kindly begin with your arguments. You can begin with your arguments now.
The proceeding has been started. You can begin.
This is the council per petition. Am I audible?
Yes, yes. Continue.
Your ladyship, the council seeks permission to start with the facts of the case.
Yeah, go ahead.
The Republic of Gautama, a densely populated country with over 1.4 billion population, is located in Southeast Asia. State of Wakanda, located in northern part of Republic of Gautama, have been increasingly reported with extremely dangerous air quality levels due to various reasons, but above all serious issues was vehicular pollution. For month of January 2020, Green Wakanda policy was introduced by Wakanda government to curb air pollution. The policy aims to reduce air pollution and increase air quality, for which an individual is just permitted to use their vehicle for 10 days in month, and if instructions are not followed, heavy fines will be charged. The policy encourages the citizens to use environmental friendly transport, that is, bicycling and practice carpooling. Use of public transport and use of public vehicle only when needed, and it encourages employers to assign employees with work from home who can't use eco-friendly transport. Individuals commuting from neighboring states are also subject to the policy. There were some exceptions as well. The policy turned out to be success. Reports were released detailing comparison between air quality levels of January 2019 with January 2020. After this remarkable achievement, Wakanda's chief minister announced policy extension for 2 years on 8th February 2020, and waves of announcement reached Gautama too. The reaction towards extension was either applauded by environmental lobby as master stroke in curbing pollution, whereas many stakeholders, including industrialists and businessmen for non-essential goods and services sector, opposed policy. Extension resulted in protest against the policy, claiming it to be restriction on fundamental liberties. However, Wakanda government didn't roll back the extension, keeping environment in concern. The fundamental liberties group filed a petition challenging the extension of Green Wakanda policy in Wakanda High Court, citing unfair restriction on Wakanda citizens' rights. Your ladyship, the council seeks permission to go ahead with the issue.
Yeah. So what is the first issue? Yeah.
Issue one is whether the petition filed by Fundamental Liberties Group is maintainable in the High Court of, in the Honorable High Court of Wakanda. Before this honorable court, the council would like to put some following points. Point number one, this petition is maintainable because it involves substantial question of laws. Point number two, an NGO is approached before this honorable high court under Article 226 of Constitution of India, and we want you to inquire into the matter. As it involves question of laws and should focus more on this policy and should also change the way of implementing this case. Petition filed by NGO is in interest of public. The policy introduced in country of Wakanda is causing difficulty to general people of Wakanda. Therefore, petition filed should be considered right. Point number three, it is humbly submitted to Honorable High Court that by making such policy, State of Wakanda has infringed fundamental rights of citizens. Point number four, Article 19, Clause 1, Subclause D, to move freely throughout the territory of India is a fundamental right, and the policy has lays restriction on movement of general public. Article 14, Article 19, and Article 21 has been violated. As held in E.P. Royappa versus State of Tamil Nadu, that arbitrariness is a part of Article 14, and the policy is arbitrary in nature. That's why it has violated the fundamental rights of citizens. In case of E.P. Royappa versus State of Tamil Nadu, the Supreme Court has drifted from the traditional concept of equality, which was based on reasonable classification, and equality with, and has laid down a new equality concept. Bhagwat J. delivering the judgment on behalf of him. Chandrachad and Krishna Iyer, J.J. propounded the new concept of equality in the following words. Equality is a dynamic concept with many aspects and dimensions, and it cannot be cribbed and confined with traditional and doctrinal limits. From a Positivistic point of view, equality and arbitrariness are sworn enemies. One belongs to the rule of law in a republic, while the other to the whim and caprice of an absolute monarch. Where an act is arbitrary, it is implicit in it that it is unequal, both according to political logic and constitutional law, and is therefore violative of Article 14. Your ladyship, Article 14 has been violated because of the reason that inequality has been done, as some of the people have been exempted. If the court is satisfied with the issue number 1, the council seeks permission to go ahead with the issue number 2.
Just a minute. But I have a question here, that the thing which you are calling is inequality can be a reasonable restriction.
Pardon, ma'am?
Can't it be called as a reasonable restriction and not inequality?
It is inequality. As discrimination is done between them, some of the people are allowed to go out and some are not. So it is an inequality.
But then if we see to curb the same air pollution, Mr. Kejriwal also have tried sometimes even odd system, and like you have to have some reasonable restrictions, right? At various instances. Otherwise,
the council seeks ignorance.
Sorry, I didn't get you.
The council seeks ignorance. Yes.
Okay, go ahead then. Go on.
Issue 2 is whether the extension of the Green Wakanda policy is constitutionally valid. Before this honorable court, the council would like to put following points. First, the extension of Green Wakanda policy is not constitutionally valid. Extension of this policy to reduce pollution is arbitrary in nature as it infringes fundamental rights of citizens. Point number 2, imposing this policy cannot be considered as exception of right to move freely. This policy is threat to liberty of citizens living in Wakanda and its bordering states. Right to life and personal liberty was given widest amplitude in Menaka Gandhi versus Union of India. In this case, court held that the procedure established by law should be reasonable. Just and fair, it shall be free from any unreasonableness and arbitrariness. It also stated that the provisions of Article 14, 19 and 21 are mutually exclusive and inseparable. The Wakanda policy by Union of India is arbitrary in nature, and it involves the personal liberty of not only of individuals, but also of the society. Article 21, equality before law. The state shall not deny to any person equality before law or the equal protection of laws within the territory of India. This right has been held to be heart of the Constitution, the most organic and progressive provision in our living Constitution. It can only be claimed when a person is deprived of his life or personal liberty by the state as defined in Article 12. Okay, if your lordship are satisfied with the issue number 2.
So here is a situation. Just tell me what will happen and is it good or a bad in nature? So there is a air pollution in the city a lot, and to curb that air pollution, and people started falling ill due to that air pollution. Okay. Are you able to understand me? So the government couldn't, obviously the government doesn't have so much infrastructure and medical facilities to treat everyone. So the government started putting price to lives. Like if you are younger in age, the government was treating you better. And after 65 of age, the government was not investing so much in protecting the life and the citizens, because obviously they had crossed a certain age where they were on their last stage of life only. So according to you, this is justified or unjustified?
This is justified because if they don't have a facility to treat everyone equally, so they so it is justified. They can just do things for youngers instead of them.
So you are saying this case is unjustified? How come this case became unjustified then? Isn't it on the similar nature and similar grounds?
But here, which the situation you gave me, there is a possibility. You know, they can do this because they don't have facilities to treat everyone. So they can just do. They can just treat youngers first, and the one who are already very the one who have passed their years, they can be like
allowed to die.
Not allowed to die, but
They were allowed to die.
But priorities should be given to youngers, no?
And so in this case, what they are doing? Compare the two cases. Yeah, here what they are doing? Tell me.
Here they are discriminating.
By doing what?
By doing, they have exempted many of the people. And they have exempted women, like they can move freely, but men are not allowed to. And many of them are allowed to move.
But don't you think the case which I told you is more gross, since they are allowing them to die? And here it's just a reasonable restriction for moving. And you are calling it inequality.
But
okay, let's go ahead. Let's go ahead. Yeah.
Therefore, in light of the issue raised, argument advanced, and authority cited, may this honorable court be pleased to: point number one, the petition is maintainable in the honorable high court. Point number two, policy should not be continued as it violates Article 14 and Article 19. And pass any other it may deem fit in the interest of justice, equality, and good conscience.
Okay. Okay, it's fair. Let's move ahead.
Your ladyship, counsel seeks permission on the behalf of respondent to go with the issue number one.
Okay, just a minute. You are R130, right?
Yes.
Okay. Throw some light on the facts again, by your perspective.
The fact stays as follows. The Republic of Gotham is a country located in Southeast Asia. It is a densely populated country. Wakanda is a state in the northern part of the country. Over the past few years, there have been increasing dangerous air quality levels, and even now the situation has been worse. And the main concern, the issue raised was the vehicular pollution. To curb this problem, of air pollution, the Wakanda government introduced a policy named Green Wakanda Policy in the month of January 2020. Under this policy, the government has put some restrictions. The first restriction was upon the number of days an individual can use the motor vehicle to communicate. Here, it states that the individual can only use their own vehicles for 10 days a month. If this thing is not followed, then heavy fines will be imposed. The second thing was they were encouraged to use eco-friendly means of transport, such as bicycle, carpooling, or public transport. Thirdly, the work from home was encouraged. Work from home was encouraged. In an extra A, a comparison report was submitted by the government. Here, the pollution level of January 2019 and pollution level of January 2020 was shown, and there was a drastic change once this policy has been introduced. Seeing better results, the government of Wakanda state introduces the government of Wakanda state tried to increase this policy on 8th February 2020. The chief minister of Wakanda announced the move for the extension of the policy. Here they said that the policy will be continued for 2 years, from January 2020 to January 2022. The environment lobby and all the environment lobby and the people who were supportive in and considered it as the master stroke. Whereas some of the people were not satisfied, like the fundamental liberty groups. That's it. These are the facts.
Okay. So what is your first issue?
First issue states that whether the petition filed by the fundamental liberty group is maintainable in the Honorable High Court of Wakanda. The counsel on behalf of the respondents says that the petition filed by the fundamental liberty groups is not maintainable under the Honorable High Court of Wakanda.
Okay. What are your reasons for this?
It is humbly submitted before this Honorable Court that the petition filed by the petitioner is not maintainable because of the following grounds. First, Article 21 of Indian Constitution includes the right to enjoy pollution-free environment. As per the facts that there have been increasing reports of the extremely dangerous air quality level in Wakanda due to vehicular pollution, to curb this, the growing menace, the government of Wakanda made the Green Wakanda policy. This policy was made keeping the health of the people in mind. The landmark judgment of M.C. Mehta versus Union of India in 2004 states that Article 21 includes the right to enjoy pollution-free environment. In support of this, the government has released the Annexure A, which clearly states the improvement of the air pollution in the state. Secondly, the council submits, the council draws your attention that there has been no violation to the fundamental rights of the petitioner or any citizen of the Wakanda state. The Article 19D is the right about is a fundamental right to move freely, but there are some restrictions under this article. The first restriction is interest of the general public. In the interest of the general public means that the state has the right or has the power to restrict the movement of the people if it is for their betterment. Here the respondent, that is the government of Wakanda, made the policy to reduce the pollution level for the betterment betterment of the citizens and to ensure this, the reasonable measures were taken. Undoubtedly, the restriction was put, but the restriction was upon the number of days an individual can use their own transport. The policy encouraged the use of environment-friendly means.
Thus the
state has power to impose reasonable restriction, and there was no fundamental violation of the citizens. And lastly, the state or the government has the power to make the policies for the welfare of the citizens under Article 47 and 162 of Indian Constitution. As the policy as it is already stated that the policy has helped in the reduction of the pollution. In the M.C. Mehta versus Union of India 1991 case, the apex court held that it is duty of the government to see that the air did not become contaminated due to the vehicular pollution. Similarly, the respondent has made Green Wakanda policy for the welfare of the people. Thus, thus all the decisions taken by the state was in good faith and upon the lawful and relevant grounds of public interest. It could have which states that the petitioner is not maintainable under this Honorable High Court.
Okay, I have a situation here.
Yes, sir.
So there is hypothetically an XYZ city. There is a lot of air pollution there, and the government start putting prices to lives, that if this person have this level of lifespan, then wo itna earn karega, economy mein contribute karega, and then we will be saving according to what contribution they will make in the society. Okay, so they are saving all the middle-aged population of the country and leaving behind the old-aged, since they have already seen a lot of life and they are at the last stage, so leaving behind those people, since they won't be earning and they are not productive and all. So human rights comes in picture to save the rights of old. Obviously, they cannot live to be died, right? They have the right to live until they are alive. So, yes. So do you think that this law is a fair enough law which they were making to save
Your Honorship, this law may not be fair, but if we see the scenario of some developed countries, even such as China, USA, Canada, these are some countries where this type of policy is followed. Here, they are not letting the older generation just to die. They're just giving more importance and preference to the younger generation, because undoubtedly, only the younger generation can help in the development of the country. If the younger generation is not protected, then this will completely create a menace, because obviously the older generation has contributed their part to the country, and now it's a chance for the younger generation. They are not letting that the older community to completely die. They are just giving the preference to the younger generation, and I don't think so that there can be any issue about it, because we can easily see that many developed countries is following this.
Okay, so we can easily follow that even odd system also, and yes, already ma'am. We have metro running.
Yes.
So I think this is enough to curb and maintain the air pollution part.
At least this is the best they can do, because the air pollution in the cities or the states is increasing because of the vehicular pollution mostly. The main reason for this is the vehicular pollution. So if we can put an end, or obviously we can't put the end, but yeah, we can try to decrease it. So this policy is quite good.
What do you think that electric vehicles can be a good alternative for it?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, Your Honorship. The electric transport can be a good alternative because there doesn't lead to any pollution level.
Okay, fair enough. Thank you.
The council seeks permission to move forward for the issue number 2.
Yes.
Issue number 2 is whether the extension of the Green Wakanda policy is constitutionally valid. It is humbly submitted before this honorable court that the government has right to make the policies and the rules for the welfare of the citizens under Article 162 of Indian Constitution. In a landmark case, M. Ashik Niamathullah versus the government of Tamil Nadu states that there is no constitutional requirement that any policy devised by the state must be implemented in one go. Policies are capable of being implemented in a phased manner. This shows that the extension of the policy done by the Wakanda state is also constitutionally valid. Council seeks permission to move forward for the prayer.
Wait for a minute.
Ma'am, the time for the respondent is already over. So, like, kindly put that, that into consideration while marking that is also.
Okay.
Ma'am, actually, when we play this kind of sound, so that means the time is up and Shreyash is going to show that placard. So, yeah.
I think I missed upon it.
Yes. No problem, ma'am. No problem, ma'am.
It's okay. Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Let her say the prayer and let's...
Yes.
Okay. Let her come.
You may proceed.
Yeah.
Wherefore, in the light of facts stated, issue raised, authority cited, and the arguments advanced, the counsel for the respondent respectfully submit, request the Honorable High Court may be pleased to dismiss the writ filed against the government, order to allow extension of the policy and pass such order as the honorable court may deem fit the interest of justice, equity, and good conscience.
Okay, thank you. Okay.
The counsel for the petitioner may proceed with the rebuttal, if any.
Petitioner, do you have any rebuts?
No.
Thank you. Your ladyship, can we conclude? Do you have any question?
No, I have asked in between only.
Yes,
yes, right now.
Thank you, Your Ladyship. So, participants, you may leave the room. Yes, you are audible. You may begin with your proceedings.
May it please the Honorable High Court, this is counsel appearing on behalf of the petitioner in the case of Fundamental Liberties Group versus State of Wakanda. Your Lordship, would you like the counsel to go over the facts or can the counsel proceed with the issues at hand?
Facts. State the facts first.
Much obliged, Your Lordship. The facts of the case are as follows. Wakanda is a state in the Republic of Gotham, but one of the major problems faced by the state is the environmental pollution. And in order to curb this, the government came out with a policy in January 2020 called the Green Wakanda Policy. Now, among other things, it seeks to curb the pollution levels by imposing restrictions on the use of private motor transport in the city. Now, besides encouraging people to use public transport. So, in the end of January 2020, the government came out with a report which said that which supposedly said that the initiative was a success. Now, it is decided to further extend this particular policy. So this, however, is not viable in the long run. So that is why the Fundamental Liberties Group has approached the Honorable High Court in order to seek a redress. So if your lordship is satisfied, could the council move ahead and start with the issues at hand?
Yes.
So issue number one, your lordship, is whether the petition before the Honorable High Court by the Fundamental Liberties Group against the Green Vakananda policy is maintainable or not. Issue one is obitus in remedium. Traditionally, only an aggrieved party that has suffered a legal injury can seek judicial redress. However, the ever-growing call for an accessible and affordable justice delivery system necessitated the expansion of the locus standing. As Justice Krishna Iyer, Municipal Council Ratlam, Mrs. Vardhichand rightly put it, shifting the center of gravity of justice from the traditional individualism of locus standi to the community orientation of public interest litigation is a constitutional mandate enshrined in the preamble. This principle was firmly established in S.P. Gupta's Union of India, where the court held that any person acting pro bono and having bona fide interest in the matter at hand can approach the court for judicial redress of any public injury. Nonetheless, the court held in T.N. Govardhan Trimulpad, which is Union of India, that if the issue is ascertained to be a question of substantial public interest, then the locus standi of the person placing the relevant materials and facts becomes irrelevant. Moreover, the impugned policy encroaches upon the fundamental rights of the people of Vakananda, namely Article 19.1d, which guarantees the freedom of movement to move freely within the territory, and Article 21 and 14 of the Constitution, as will be explained shortly, and therefore warrants the attention of this august forum to safeguard the interests of people of Vakananda. Article 226, Clause 1 of the Gautam Constitution confers upon the High Court the power to issue any person or authority appropriate directions, orders, or writs for the enforcement of any of the rights conferred by Part 3 of the Constitution, which deals with fundamental rights. Therefore, it is humbly submitted by the petitioner that the instant petition is maintainable before the High Court. If your lordship is satisfied, could the council proceed with issue number two?
Yes.
Whether the Green Vakananda issue number much obliged, your lordship. Issue number two is whether the Green Vakananda policy is constitutionally valid. The Stockholm Declaration on Human Environment is a historic document that seeks to shed light on the significance and salience of people in preserving the natural environment and attempts to forge a link between human rights and environmental protection by proclaiming that both aspects of a man's environment, the natural and the man-made, are essential to his well-being and to the enjoyment of basic human rights, including the right to life itself. The four core dimensions of sustainable development, namely economic, environmental, social, and institutional, are all important in equal measure, and one cannot be compared of another. Amidst the ever-increasing concerns in present times around environmental pollution and its deleterious effects on people, care must be taken to ensure that the most important factor, that is the rights and liberties of people, are not lost sight of. For a society is nothing without its people. As pointed out by the court in Rural Litigation Entitlement Kendra, State of UP, a balancing act needs to be performed by the court in order to reconcile the growing conflicts between conservation and development in the larger interests of the country. This fight against alarming pollution levels should be a people's battle, where people are persuaded by increasing their awareness and providing incentives to switch to more eco-friendly modes of transport, and not coerced into submission by imposing heavy fines on violators and unreasonable curbs on the exercise of fundamental rights. It has been viewed through this prism, my lordship, that the present move by the Vakananda government becomes a cause for concern. Although the initiative is appreciable for its good intentions, the point of contention arises from the fact that the impugned policy seeks to achieve its object at the expense of the much cherished individual freedoms. In Gautam, a country predicated on the principle of rule of law, the Supreme Court has held in Dharyo that liberty of the individual and protection of its fundamental rights are the very essence of the democratic way of life. And it's the privilege and duty of the court to uphold those rights. The two words in Article 21 of significant import are life and personal liberty. In Maneka Gandhi, the court has emphasized that personal liberty must be given an expansive interpretation and that it is of widest amplitude, covering a wide variety of rights. Hence, it can be safely inferred that an integral aspect of personal liberty of an individual is the right to move freely or travel within the territory of the country. This implies the right of the citizens to choose how to travel and where to travel. In Karak Singh's State of UP, the court has observed that the expression personal liberty is a comprehensive one and the right to move is freely is an attribute of personal liberty. Further, my lordship, personal liberty is further fortified under Article 19. And as propounded by Menaka Gandhi, any state action that violates Article 21 has to satisfy the tests under Article 19 and 14 as well. Furthermore, the court has read into Article 21 the qualitative attribute of life and accepted the viewpoint that whatever promotes the quality of life of an individual falls within the parameters of Article 21, thereby extending the right to life beyond basic necessities of life. Thus, the right to determine one's mode of commute in the context of right to travel is an essential facet of the right to a convenient life, which in turn is an integral aspect of right to life. So when restrictions are imposed on the freedom to move freely, the policy amounts to a violation of both right to life and personal liberty. If right to a comfortable life as an important facet of right to life is one thing, it is another established view in Olga Tellis that the right to life includes the right to livelihood. Hence, it cannot be taken away in an arbitrary.
Okay, there's a question. Justify why you have mentioned BALCO Employees Union versus Union of India. Justify this case law with perspective of the situation. That how this case law is applied here. You mentioned it in your memorial.
Certainly, Your Lordship. So, BALCO employees case was mentioned because towards the end, because that was a case in which it was highlighted by the court that if a policy violates, that intervention of a court was warranted if the policy is contrary to the law or does not stick to, is malified or as provisions that are contrary to law, only then the court will intervene and seek to provide remedy. As in this particular case, so this was a policy that was brought by the state government, and the petitioner felt it was necessary to mention that the court has the jurisdiction to interfere in matters of policy making if it is contrary to any provisions of law.
But it says where there is malafide intention. So explain malafide intention in this situation now beyond doubts.
Certainly, Your Lordship. Apart from malafide intention, it also says if it's contrary to law or any law or constitution. Okay.
Explain anything contrary to which law or
certainly, Your Lordship.
Yeah.
Yes, certainly, Your Lordship. This policy violates the fundamental rights, which is part of the Constitution of Gotham. So, if that is the case, then the petitioner would
has reasonable restrictions, right? You do not have the entire liberty to enjoy all the fundamental rights. We are sitting in lockdown from 3 months. Isn't it breach of our fundamental right of moving? Then we should be moving around. Why are we sitting
thank you for the question, Lordship. But in case Puttaswamy versus Union of India, the Supreme Court has laid down a test of reasonability, that the four conditions which have to be satisfied. And the petitioner would like to seek the opportunity to state as to why this particular policy does not meet the conditions that have been imposed on the people. Could the petitioner state the reasons, Lordship?
Yeah, sure. Go ahead.
So as per the case Puttaswamy versus Union of India case, there are four conditions that have to be met. First is the question of legitimate goal. While the green Vakananda policy meets the first condition, it does not meet the other three conditions, which is that the second one is the one second Lodge. The second one is. Yeah, the second one as to whether there is a rational nexus. The policy at hand aims at eliminating the menace of pollution from state of Vakananda. But the modus operandi of the policy unfortunately only addresses the symptoms and not the root cause of the problem. The policy fails to prove how implementing the policy for a certain period of time, say 2 years, can permanently make Vakananda pollution free. Instead, such stopgap arrangements only put citizens to avoidable hardships. As far as the necessity stage is concerned, the third stage, the Chief Minister's Vakananda has already announced that his government would take measures to encourage the use of public transport. So when much less restrictive options, including making public transport more affordable, accessible, and creating separate cycling lanes remain open, it is but natural for one to conclude that the difficulty that the people of the state are going to be put through is not warranted in the first place. As to the disproportionate impact, It is imperative for us to understand that the ambient air quality around us has the ambient air as both natural as well as man-made pollutants. The point is that we must not forget that humans are not the sole source of pollution. But the policy in question squarely puts the blame on citizens and expects them to bear the entire brunt of the burden. If anything, the policy seeks to punish citizens for wanting to exercise their right to a comfortable life, which is an essential part of the right to life. For life, as declared by the Honorable Court, goes beyond mere animal needs of man. Not to mention that the move is against the established notions of fairness as well. On a plain reading of the Annexure B, it can be said that the language used by the state, insofar as industrial establishments are concerned, is ambiguous and vague, with no definitions or explanations provided for words such as essential, production, and continuous process. What the clause essentially does is to bestow upon the executive the discretion to determine the operational status of industrial establishments. On the other hand, for common people, it's a blanket ban, which specifically mentioned exempted categories of work.
No, it is not a blanket ban. Have you read the facts?
Your ladyship, sorry to interrupt. She is already running out of time. It's over by almost 4 or 5 minutes.
Okay. Just conclude. What is your prayer? Come to the prayer.
Yes, Lordship. In light of the issues raised, arguments advanced, and authorities cited, it is humbly prayed by the council before the Honorable Court to hold this instant petition maintainable, and then there is a violation of fundamental rights, namely Article 14, 19 and 21, and that the policy is constitutionally invalid, and also the council would like to pray for any other relief that the Honorable Court feel may be pleased to grant in the interest of justice, equity and conscience.
Okay. Let's move on.
Thank you. With the permission of the Lordship, the Council would like to rest our case.
Yes.
Okay. Yes, you may proceed.
Your Ladyship, I am the counsel on behalf of the respondents in the present case, that is Fundamental Liberties Group versus State of Wakanda. Your Ladyship may kindly note that my team code is R410. If your Ladyship is well versed with the facts and issues of the case, the council seeks permission to begin with the arguments advanced.
First, tell me your issues. What the issues that you have framed?
Your Ladyship, I, the counsel for the respondent, will be dealing with issue number two issues. Whether the petition filed by the Fundamental Liberties Group is maintainable before this Honorable High Court. The issue shall be dealt in four folds. That is, number one, the Green Wakanda policy implemented by the State of Wakanda does not breach or violate the fundamental rights of the petitioners. Number two, no form of writ or directions arises since the petition under Article 226 in the present case is not maintainable. Number three, the success of the petition in the instant case shall lead to infringement of fundamental rights of the State of Wakanda under Article 14 and Article 21 of the Constitution of the Republic of Gotham. With respect to the first fold, Your Ladyship, the Council submits before this Honorable High Court that the implementation of the said policy is only for a period of 2 years. Therefore, there is no blanket ban on the movement of vehicles. Thus, the policy is for a temporary period and is not absolute. The petition filed by the petitioners is completely malafide, bad in law, and with the motive to mislead this Honorable Court. The claim of the petitioners that the said policy has violated the fundamental rights of the petitioners under Article 14, under Article 19, and under Article 21 is completely an ill-fated claim and need not be entertained. With respect to Article 19, Your Ladyship, the respondents humbly submit before this Honorable Court that there is no absolute restrictions in the freedom of movement of the petitioners. The petitioners are constrained from using their individual vehicles only for a period of 10 days in a month, wherein exception in case of emergency is provided even during such period. In such a period, the petitioners are encouraged to use eco-friendly modes of transport such as bicycles, carpooling, and public transport, etc. This clearly establishes that there is no complete or absolute restrictions of movement of the petitioners, since they are at liberty to use any of the eco-friendly modes available to them as mentioned earlier. Further, your ladyship, Article 19 of the Constitution is subjected to a reasonable restriction clause, which is imposed by the state under Article 19, Subclause 5 of the Constitution. Your ladyship, Article 19, Subclause 5 states that the law authorizing externment or internment to be valid must be within the limits of permissible legislation. That is, restrictions of the right of the freedom of movement must be reasonable and in the interest of the general public or for the protection of the interest of the scheduled tribes. With respect to Article 19, Subclause 5, your ladyship, the council seeks permission to draw your attention to the case of... just a second, your ladyship.
But don't you think that the implication of reasonable restriction has been a lot more widened and generalized here?
Indeed, your ladyship, it is generalized, but your ladyship, the stake of...
But if it is generalized, then it is bad in nature. That means the law is wrong.
Indeed, your ladyship, however, the council differs on the point of opinion.
You agree that the law is wrong?
No, your ladyship. The law is subjected to a reasonable clause, which is under Article 19.5.
Saying that the reasonable restriction has to be very specific when it is applied. And
indeed,
in
leadership.
This situation, it has been generalized.
Your ladyship, the
which
council
makes shall... law arbitrary.
Your ladyship, the council shall deal with this issue in the further set of the arguments, wherein it will explain to you that the present law, which has been used by the council for the respondents, is not arbitrary. Your ladyship, the council would like to draw your attention to the case of Municipal Corporation of the City of Ahmedabad versus Jan Mohammad Usman Bhai, wherein the courts have held that the fundamental rights are subjected to a reasonable restrictions and the same can be imposed by the state where there is breach of mass fundamental violations. Your ladyship, the council, with respect to Article 21, submits before this honorable court that the Article 21 states that no person shall be deprived of his life and personal liberty except according to procedures established by law. Your ladyship, ignorance of a fact is an excuse, but ignorance of a law is not an excuse. The petitioners are construing only such part of the provisions of Article 21 as is important to them, that is, the liberty clause. However, the second part of the provision cannot also be undermined, that the restrictions on Article 21 can be imposed by applying due procedure of the law. And your ladyship, the state of Wakanda have used this the second part of the clause, that is, the Green Wakanda policy has been implemented only after the due procedure of the law has been taken into consideration. If the present petition succeeds, the fundamental rights and the interests of large number of public will be affected, as the pollution level will again rise in the state, leading to large scale implications on the life of on the health of the people of Wakanda. Moreover, the petitioners belong to a class of community which can afford to commute in their private vehicle, which clearly implies that the rest of the society who cannot afford the same would be directly exposed to the deteriorating air quality of the state of Wakanda, which will severely affect the health and life of the commoners. Your ladyship, an individual cannot enjoy the fruit of liberty by endangering the lives of the fellow citizens of the state. And if the individual does so, the state has all the right to curtail such freedoms according to the procedure established by law. Your ladyship, the respondents further submit before this honorable court that the Article 226 can be invoked only when there is a violation of fundamental rights of the petitioners. The respondents have clearly put forth before the honorable court through its arguments that there is no violation of fundamental rights as of
how
the petitioners.
How come there is no violation of fundamental right? They are just allowed to move for 10 days. They are not allowed to take public vehicles.
Sorry, your ladyship, the council would like to differ on this point. Your ladyship, there is not a blanket ban on the restriction. During the period of 10 days when the petitioners are not allowed to use their vehicles, in that case, your ladyship, there is another mode of transport which is available to them, that is mode of eco-friendly transport. Your ladyship,
but
the council
everyone
agrees,
cannot ride bicycle.
Indeed, your ladyship,
I won't be taking bicycle indeed, for sure.
Indeed, your ladyship, for that instance, you have carpooling as an option, and also you have an option of private of using public vehicle, your ladyship. Your ladyship, I'll be further covering this point which you raised in the course of my argument. Your ladyship,
and
the respondents.
How come doctrine of polluters pay principle can be applied? They must be paying taxes. They must be already paying taxes to the government. Why polluters pay principle again should be applied to them?
Indeed, your ladyship, I would like to draw your attention to annexure A of this of the proposition, wherein, your ladyship, you can see that the air quality index of January 2019 and January 2020 has been compared. Wherein, your ladyship, if you take a keen look on January 1st, 2019, it was the air quality index was 412, while that of January 2020, when the scheme was implemented, was 445. And your ladyship, if you draw your attention to the data of 31st January 2019,
just
the air quality.
Mention the page number. I'm not able to find this data.
Your ladyship, it is in the preposition in annexure A. Your ladyship.
Just a minute. Let me see. Okay. Got it. Yeah.
Your ladyship, if you have a keen look on the data of January 2019, the air quality index was 378. Whereas when the said policy was implemented, that is January 31st, the air quality index has reduced to 70 to the data of 70, which clearly shows that the majority reason or concern which arises was due to the vehicular pollution which was in the state of Wakanda. And therefore, your ladyship, this scheme clearly states that if a person is using or if it is not following the law or not following the policy, the same will be punished with heavy fines. If your ladyship is convinced, the council would like to proceed with the further arguments. Indeed, your ladyship. The respondents therefore humbly plead before this honorable court that the interest of large number of people cannot be compromised in lieu of the convenience of a few. Your ladyship, the respondents humbly submit before this honorable court that there is no violation of fundamental rights of any of its citizens of Republic of Gautam, and therefore the petition is filed by the petitioner is not maintainable and therefore be outrightly rejected. If your ladyships are quite convinced with the arguments, the council would proceed with issue number 2.
Yes, I think your time is over or what?
No, your ladyship, the bell hasn't rung.
Okay.
Your ladyship, issue number 2 states that, and I quote, whether the extension of Green Wakanda policy is constitutionally valid. Your ladyship, the council shall deal with this issue in two folds, that is, state government's ambit under part 4 of the Indian Constitution, comprising of Article 48 and Article 51 AG, setting up of Air Prevention and Control of Pollution Act in 1981, and state government has formulated the Green Wakanda policy without breaching its jurisdiction. Your ladyship, with respect to the first fold, Article 48A states that the state shall endeavor to protect and improve the environment and safeguard the forest and wildlife of the country. Your ladyship, the countries by adopting the literal construction rule can conclude that it is a duty of the state to protect and improve the environment. Applying the same principle of literal construction to Article 51 AG, the courts can further conclude that it is also the fundamental duty of every citizen of the country to protect and improve the natural environment, including forests, rivers, lakes, and wildlife. Moreover, your ladyship, you may have a kind look at the statute, the Air Prevention and Control of Air Pollution Act in 1981, the state, wherein it states that the state government has constituted for the state of for the state a state pollution control board and prevention of air pollution constituted under section 5 of the act, and accordingly the state pollution control board shall, without prejudice to the exercise and performance of its powers and functions under that act, exercise the powers and functions of the state board for the prevention and control of air pollution under this act. Therefore, your
council, sorry to interrupt, your time is over for 5 minutes.
Okay, let's just come to the prayer then. I understand. Indeed. I have already read the memorandum. Okay.
Indeed, your ladyship. Your Ladyship, the council would begin with the prayers. Much obliged. Yes. Wherefore, in the light of the issues raised, arguments advanced, and authorities cited, this Honorable Court may be pleased to first outrightly reject the instant petition, since the petition suffers from the lack of jurisdiction, is misconceived and bad in law. Second, health and safety of the citizens is a matter of paramount importance, and therefore the Green Wakanda policy be implemented in the state for a period of 2 years with immediate effect. Number three, declare the state Green Wakanda policy to be a law until such period whereby the air quality index in the state improves. Number four, declare that no other petition with regards to the said policy be heard in future, thereby giving priority to the health and safety of the citizens or convenience of a few, and or any other order, direction or relief that this Honorable Court may be deemed fit in the interest of equity, justice and good conscience, all of which is humbly prayed. Team Court R410, Council for the Respondents.
Okay.
Council for the side of petitioner, do you have any rebuts?
Lordship, can the council, has 2-3 counter arguments. Lordship, can the council ask?
You may proceed.
Your Lordship, so the respondent in this case has said that as far as reasonable restrictions under Article 19 is concerned, in Bennett Coleman case, it has been clearly mentioned by the court that it is not the subject matter or substance of a regulatory provision that matters, but rather it is a consequence or effect of the impugned state action. Now, in this case, the impugned policy, in the guise of protecting people from harmful effects of vehicular pollution, seeks to impose unreasonable curbs on the freedom of movement of individuals by restricting usage of privately owned vehicles to just 10 days a month. And as far as Article 21 of the Gotham Constitution is concerned, the respondent has mentioned that the due procedure has been followed. But the Lordship, the Council would like to bring to the notice of the Lordship that in today's times, there is increasing number of people who are engaged in app-based gig economy, for whom we have drivers and food delivery personnel, for whom usage of a private vehicle is an essential part of the right means of livelihood. Now, how, and also the automobile sector is a potential employment generator. Now, if due procedure has been followed, the council would like to submit the due procedure has not been followed, because all of these people are staring at an imminent threat of joblessness. They will all these people will lose their jobs. Now, there is no safety net that has been provided for all of these people. And this also speaks for the blanket ban that I was talking about, my Lordship, because in this case, for these people, there is no provision that they can approach the government for provision, for exemption. Whereas for industrial establishments, in Annexure B, the government has mentioned that certain production units can take a prior permission of the state government and function. Now, how are these people going? They are not performing essential services. So how will they go about carrying out their day-to-day activities and earn their livelihood? Also, Lordship, the council would like to say, as far as directive principles are concerned, it has been clearly laid down in the Kerala Education Bill case that there is no question of one having primacy over the other. Fundamental rights having primacy over the other, or directive principles having primacy over the other. It is a principle of harmonious construction. So both the interests have to be taken into consideration before arriving at any policy, Your Lordship.
Yes, so this is what, intervene in this question, that there has to be a balance between them, and that's why they are being restricted, because they need fresh air to breathe also, no? Otherwise, if they don't...
Yes, Lordship. Certainly, Your Lordship. Certainly, the council agrees with your point that they need clean air to breathe. But at the same time, as pointed out by the petitioner in the question of the necessity, when the government can make use of public transport, encourage the use of public transport, making them more affordable, as the respondent has mentioned in his memorial, that usage of public transport actually is a little difficult. Is mentioned in the memorial. When the government can take measures to make more public transport more affordable and accessible, why can't the government first start with that measure and before imposing restrictions on the people? Restrictions should be the last resort, and infringement of fundamental rights should not be the first resort. Rather, it should be the last resort.
But every fundamental rights comes with a reasonable restriction. Now, it is not a blanket ban. It is just
yes, Lordship, like, but...
control the situation. Like, we are sitting in lockdown right now. So this is not an infringement of fundamental rights, right? This is a necessity.
Certainly, Your Lordship. Certainly, Your Lordship. This is a necessity. I agree, Your Lordship, the present lockdown. But in this case, in the present case, there is no choice. But
Council,
in the case
sorry
of vehicular pollution, we have...
Council, sorry to interrupt. Your time is over for almost 2-3 minutes now.
Okay, Your Lordship.
Thank you, Council.
Lordship, can I conclude?
Your Ladyship, just to inform with utmost respect that the time is also over, at least she can conclude within 30 seconds. No further time.
Okay. Just conclude it in short.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lordship. Thank you so much, Lordship. Yeah. So the petitioner wanted to say that as far as development is concerned, we need to take into consideration both environment as well as the rights and liberties of people. As in the present case, we have no other choice. Lockdown is necessary, infringement of fundamental rights. But as far as the vehicular pollution case is concerned, there is an option of resorting to other remedies, which could be availed without infringing on our fundamental rights. That is all the petitioner would like to state, Your Lordship.
Thank you.
Okay, perfect.
Your Ladyship, may I have the privilege to raise some sour rebuttals?
Let's just ask them if they have time. If there is time, then you can.
Yes, you may proceed for sir rebuttal, but your time limit is only one limit. 1 minute.
Okay.
Indeed.
You have 1 minute then.
Your Ladyship, the petitioners have clearly misleading the courts, whereas here in the instant case, the petitioners are the business class community and not the other, as mentioned by the petitioners. Moreover, the Green Wakanda policy is a step as in way of a force measures which has been implemented. Moreover, the judgments cited by the learned counsel for the petitioners are completely different to the subject matter of the dispute with regards to the present case. Your Ladyship, moreover, the counsel has relied on the oral statements of your lordships in various judgments, which is amounting to an obiter dicta and not a ratio decidendi. Your Ladyship, lastly, liberty for few cannot be used as a tool or a weapon when the receiving end of it are common citizens of the state of Wakanda. With this, Your Ladyship, I would humbly like to rest my case.
Okay.
Your Ladyship, do you have any question from the round?
I ask in between only. There are no questions.
Thank you, Your Ladyship.
Okay.
Participants, you may leave the room.
Have the participants left?
Mausam, kindly remove her. You can also remove her being the host.
I have.
Greetings to the bench. The council would be representing Fundamental Liberties Group. In the case of Fundamental Liberties Group versus the state of Wakanda, the council seeks permission to refer to the bench as your lordship and leaderships.
Yes.
The council has approached this under the court in exercise of its jurisdiction under Article 226, if the council seeks permission to go through the facts of the case.
I'm sorry to say you are not clearly audible. Can you be a bit loud? Just a bit loud.
The council seeks permission to proceed with the facts of the case.
Yes. Go ahead.
Your Lordship, this is a simple case of executive policy being challenged based on its constitutionality. There was a Green Wakanda policy that was implemented so as to reduce the pollution in the state of Wakanda. The policy restricts use of motor vehicles for more than a period of 10 days in 1 month. The policy was later on in February 2019 extended for the period of 2 years. And provided with some exceptions that are given in the annexures. The said policy has been challenged by the Fundamental Liberties Group, which is a registered society, working towards holding fundamental liberties of the citizens, upholding the fundamental liberties of the citizens, and has been challenged before the court. If the court is satisfied with the statement of issue, the council seeks permission to proceed to the issues of the
case. Yes, yes.
Your Lordship, the first issue is the maintainability of the repetition, and the second issue is whether the Green Vakana policy is unconstitutional or not. First of all, Your Lordship, the council has approached this honorable court in exercise of its power under Article 226. The court can exercise its power of judicial review in this present case in cases such as Ram Singh Vijay Pal versus clearly can be based on the constitutionality.
You are not audible.
It is a different matter.
You're not clearly audible. Yeah.
It is a different matter whether we are when the court goes into whether the policy is efficient or not. That is not the question here. The question today is just that whether this policy is unconstitutional or not. It is whether it is violating some fundamental rights in this present case or not. As to the extent of its violation of fundamental right, whether there is an arbitrary action on the part of the state, or whether there is an excessive restriction or an abuse of power, these questions can be entertained and the court is not barred from it. Thus, the court is well within this, its power to exercise, to adjudicate upon the case. Furthermore, Your Lordship, the petitioner is a registered society. It is working for the welfare of the citizens so as to uphold its civil liberties. The court, during the cases of PIL, has always taken a liberal interpretation so as to allow the masses to find a judicial redress for public injuries wherein any person who has sufficient interest and is acting in a bona fide manner can approach the court and will have locus standi in the particular case. As such, in the instant case, the petitioner, a registered society, has the locus standi to come before the court. Other than that, Your Lordship, comes the matter of alternative remedy. Your Lordship, 226 is indeed a discretionary remedy. However, in the present case, there is no alternative remedy. Your Lordship, we are challenging the constitutional validity of a statute of a policy. As such, the power of judicial review has been only limited to the high courts or the Supreme Court. There is no other tribunal which we could approach for finding a remedy. As there is no alternative remedy, the petitioner is right in coming before this court. Even if there was a remedy, Your Lordship, the court is just not disbarred based on the availability of alternative remedy. It is just a discretionary power. It's a rule of self-imposition that the court would not take a remedy. However, the court can do away the same if it feels like the matter is important enough for to be entertained. The court has wide amplitudes of power in exercise of its power of 226, and as such is not bogged down by any technical difficulties to entertain the matter. If Your Lordship is satisfied with the first issue, the council seeks permission to move to the second issue.
How can you say that there is no alternate remedy in this?
Just Your Lordship, because yes, Your Lordship. Your Lordship, I may?
Yes.
Your Lordship, we are here challenging an executive action and we are challenging it on the basis of its unconstitutionality. Sure, we are asking for enforcement of fundamental rights, but via it, we are challenging the constitutionality of a law.
Justify the unconstitutional part. What do you think is unconstitutional?
And Your Lordship, that is what the council is dealing with in the second issue, that there are the provisions of the policy are such that it is violating the right to move freely, the right to trade, that both of which are given under Article 19, 1, Clause 5 and 6, and also that it is arbitrary and it is violating Article 14, and that it takes away the citizen's right to earn livelihood, that is Article 21. All of this are prima facie being restricted, your lordship. Whether the policy is reasonable or not, that is a matter to be seen later. However, the current matter is whether there is an infringement and whether there is a prima facie case that there is a violation of fundamental right. If there is a prima facie case, then the case would be maintainable before this honorable court, your ladyship.
So you are negating the fact of having a prima facie case. What do
we
you want
have
to
a prima facie case, and that is what we are establishing.
I think in between you said otherwise. Okay, go ahead.
Sorry, your lordship.
Go ahead.
Yes. Your lordship, moving on to issue two, which is regarding whether the policy is constitutionally valid or not, your lordship. First of all, your lordship, according to the facts of the present case, there is no indication that there is any statutory backing to this executive action, your lordship. This executive action has just been introduced as a policy, your lordship. If it was indeed backed by a statute, then it could have been validly considered as a law under Article 13. However, such is not the case. If a law has to restrict the fundamental rights, which are the essence of a person's existence in this current polity, they have to be a law as per the definition. Because all of these articles that say that which imposes reasonable restrictions or other provisions, all of them themselves say that there should be a valid law. As such, this seems to be just an executive action. It has been held in some cases, your lordship, that a purely executive action cannot take away a fundamental right unless it is backed by a statutory authority. In this present case, there is no statutory authority that has made this order. It is just an executive action. As such, it is not a law. Even if it was a law, your lordship, there are certain conditions that it must fulfill to restrict the citizen's fundamental rights. First of all, your lordship, I would go on to establish that there is a fundamental right here. Article 19(1)(d), which says that the citizens have a right to move freely throughout the territory of India, is qualified by the term freely. Freely here means that the right here is in absolution, only confined by the limitation put by subclause 5, subsection 5, your lordship.
But it is not a blanket ban, right?
Sorry, your lordship?
It would have been infringement when it would have been blanket ban.
Yes, your lordship. It is not a complete ban, your lordship. Of course, your lordship. However,
then how it is infringing the fundamental rights?
There does not need to be a blanket ban for there to be infringement of fundamental rights. The fundamental right should be restricted to a level that is not reasonable. If the restriction itself is not reasonable, then the fundamental right would be violated. It is not necessary that there should be
the even odd system, which sometimes comes in function in Delhi, comes and goes. So it is infringement of fundamental right, because if I have an even vehicle, even number vehicle, I cannot go out on odd days. So according to you, that is infringement.
First of all, your lordship, in the odd even system, your lordship, in 30 days, you can at least use your vehicle for 15 days. That is a different factor. Second of all, that odd-even policy was only imposed for a short period of time. The courts have held in numerous occasions, while considering whether a policy is reasonable or not, you also have to factor in that whether what is the period, whether the policy or the regulation is permanent or temporary.
Counsel, you are inaudible.
You are not audible, yes.
Just repeat the last sentence. Yeah, just repeat the last sentence.
Your lordship, just because a law is reasonable for a short period, does not mean that it would be unreasonable for a longer period. If a law is reasonable for a very short period of time, does not mean ipso facto that it would be reasonable for a longer period of time. The factors depend based on the duration and the urgency of the law. As you would see, your lordship.
Have you seen the duration?
The duration has been imposed for a period of 2 years till 2022, Your Lordship. And if you will see at the annexure A, Your Lordship, the pollution decrease within 30. That means
I'm very sorry to interrupt, but the time is over. So how much extension do you want to grant?
No, I don't want to grant because he is not audible also. So I think he should
conclude with the prayer.
Counselor, you may conclude with the prayer.
Yeah. Go ahead and conclude with the prayer.
Whereof in the light of the issues raised, argument advanced and authorities cited, it is prayed that this Honorable Court be pleased to hold that the writ petition is maintainable, the extension of the Green Government policy is unconstitutional, and or issue any writ, pass any other order, direction or relief that this Honorable Court may deem fit in the interest of justice, fairness, equity and good conscience. For this act of kindness, the petitioner in duty bound shall humbly pray.
Okay. Thank you.
Counsel for the side of respondent, you may proceed.
And petitioner, now that you are on mute, you can turn on your video. That would be fine.
Greetings to the bench. The counsel seeks permission to address the bench as your ladyship.
Yes, go ahead.
Much obliged, Your Ladyship. The counsel is appearing on behalf of the respondents, that is the state of Wakanda. May the counsel proceed with the statement of jurisdiction?
Yes, go ahead.
Much obliged, Your Ladyship. This Honorable Court has the power to adjudge or dispose of the instant matter vested to it under Article 226 of the Constitution. If Your Ladyship is well versed with the facts of the case, may the counsel proceed with the statement of issues?
Yes.
Much obliged, Your Ladyship. Issue number one is whether the petition filed by the Fundamental Liberties Group, maintainable in the Honorable High Court of Wakanda. And issue number two is whether the extension of the Green Wakanda policy constitutionally valid. The counsel will be dealing with both the issues in the due course of arguments. The counsel seeks permission to proceed with issue number one.
Yeah, go ahead.
Much obliged, Your Ladyship. Issue number one is about the maintainability of the said petition. The council would like to humbly submit that before this honorable court, that the petition filed by the appellants is not maintainable. This said petition has been filed under Article 226 for the alleged violation of Article 19, Clause 1, Subclause D, and Article 19, Clause 1, Subclause G, which covers the right to move freely throughout the territory of Gotham, and the right to carry on any occupation, trade, or practice any profession, as per the fact sheet in paragraph 2, line 4, and line 12. However, the respondent contends that there is no infringement of fundamental rights in the said case, as the impugned policy's extension mentioned in the fact sheet, paragraph 3, line 4, comes under the ambit of reasonable restrictions as per Article 19, Clause 5 and 19, Clause 6 of the Constitution. That is the restrictions imposed in the interest of general public, in the instant matter, public safety and public health. In the case of Asha Underwater Services Private Limited versus State of Maharashtra, as cited on page 17 of the memorial on behalf of respondents, the Honorable High Court of Bombay observed that the exercise of power of judicial review would be called for if the approach of the authority is arbitrary or malafide, or the procedure is said to favor one. Here, the government of Wakanda formulated and extended the said policy in the interest of the people of Wakanda so as to provide a sustainable environment and improve their health. Given the present circumstances, the air quality of the state of Wakanda had deteriorated to such an extent that it was an imperative on behalf of the government of Wakanda to implement such a policy so as to curb the menace of air pollution in the state of Wakanda due to vehicular emissions, and due to the positive results of the said policy as visible in Annexure A of the fact sheet, the government decided to extend it from 1 month to 2 years or until further notice. The government did not banish the use of vehicles completely, but provided reasonable restrictions as mentioned in Annexure B of the fact sheet. It also made efforts to increase public transport so as to facilitate travel for the citizens of Wakanda, as stated in paragraph 3, line 16 of the fact sheet. Moreover, impugned policy of the government was in furtherance of Section 17, Clause 1, Subclause A, Section 18, Clause 1, Subclause B, and Section 19, Clause 4 of the Air Prevention and Control of Pollution Act 1981, Section 3, Clause 2, Subclause 1 of the Environment Protection Act 1986, as cited on page 18 and 19 of the memorial. Also, the petitioners have not exhausted the alternative remedy available to them under Section 14 of the National Green Tribunal Act 2010, which provides jurisdiction to the National Green Tribunal in all civil cases relating to environment. However, the remedy available under Article 226 is a discretionary remedy, and the court may grant or refuse such relief in certain circumstances. But as per the case of UP Jal Nigam versus Nareshwar Sahai Mathur, as cited on page 21 of the memorial, it was held that where the statutory remedies are available or a statutory tribunal has been set up, a petition under Article 226 should not be entertained unless the statutory remedies are ill-suited to meet the demands of the extraordinary situation. In the case of Kailash Kalmakar Chogle versus Sanjay Gandhi National Park Eco-Sensitive Zone Control Committee, cited on page 21 of the memorial, it was held that the petition filed before the Honorable Court is not maintainable, referring to Section 3 of the Environment Protection Act 1986 and Section 14 of the NGT Act 2010. Thus, the Council humbly submits that the instant petition filed by the appellants is not maintainable before this Honorable Court. If your ladyship is satisfied with the arguments presented for issue 1, the council seeks permission to proceed with issue 2.
Wait for a minute. I'll just see. See, what if there is an alternative remedy, but I don't want to go for an alternative remedy. I have major motion picture in my head and I want to go for the main motion. So,
indeed, yeah.
The indeed, case which I have mentioned here, Sisley Calicut versus Vehicle Factory, is not justifying this situation, according to me. I mean, if you can throw some light on this.
Which case law,
Your Ladyship? Page number 21 of your memorandum. Sisley Caracal versus Vehicle Factory.
Okay.
Yes. Because alternative remedy is not hierarchical in nature, that you have to take it.
Indeed, Your Lordship, it is a it is not a bar but an exception.
Yes.
But alternative remedies in certain cases have been formed so as to provide speedy redressal of grievances in certain cases at different levels, such as the State Pollution Control Board or Central Pollution Control Board or any other statutory authority and any other relevant laws. That is why for speedy redressal of this instant petition, the petitioner should have approached the National Green Tribunal first. However, if they would not have
because
been...
It is direct infringement of fundamental right. Why they should go to NGT when they could directly come to Supreme Court under it?
Indeed, Your Lordship. But the present case also involves a certain grave concern about the environment as per Article 21 of the Constitution. And the NGT was established to deal with such cases of right to pollution-free environment, etc., so as to solve these cases. So the petitioner should have approached. However, if they would not have been satisfied with the decision granted by the National Green Tribunal, they can make an appeal against it in the Supreme Court. So this set procedure has been laid down so as to provide an effective remedy to provide speedy redressal in such cases.
And this case, which you have mentioned on page number 24, Lochner versus New York, the test to be applied is not whether a judge personally considers particular restriction unreasonable, but whether a reasonable man would necessarily consider them unreasonable. Indeed. So this is the exact situation.
Indeed, Your Ladyship. But as the fact sheet also mentioned that a certain section of the non-essential sectors have been majorly affected by the said policies extension. So as the impugned policies extensions is in the interest of people of the state, citizens of Wakanda, so reasonability will here lie on protecting the health and providing a sustainable environment for the people of Wakanda, because if such pollution levels continue to rise, I am afraid that the current pandemic situations we are going through, even after it is over, we will be forced to use the masks when we step out of the houses, because of the pollution level will be so high, and it could even lead to a second situations like the Bhopal gas tragedy also. So to prevent such a situation, the government, as well as in the execution of the said policies, is required to prevent such situations. That is where the reasonability of the said impugned policy lies.
Okay, you can come to your prayer.
Indeed, Your Lordship.
Yes, come to your prayer.
Therefore, in the light of facts stated, issues raised, arguments advanced, and authorities cited, it is humbly prayed by the respondent that this Honorable Court may be pleased to declare the instant petition filed by the Fundamental Liberties Group as not maintainable in the Honorable High Court of Wakanda, and declare the extension of the Green Wakanda policy passed by the government of Wakanda as constitutionally valid, and pass any other order, direction, or relief that it may deem fit in the best interest of justice, fairness, equity, and good conscience. For this act of kindness, the respondent shall duty bound forever pray.
Okay.
Thank you, counsel. Counsel, from the side of petitioner, do you have any rebuttal? Petitioner counsel, firstly you mute your video and then start with the rebuttals.
Your Lordship, first of all, on the front page of petitioner respondent memorial, it says, yeah, mentioned that they have used this for in civil appellate jurisdiction. This is not the civil appellate jurisdiction, Your Lordship, or if it is within original jurisdiction of the High Court. Furthermore, Your Lordship, the petitioner could never approach the NGT in this matter, Your Lordship, because the such an order restricting vehicular, motor vehicular movement, it has to be passed under the Motor Vehicles Act, Your Lordship, which under Section 115 of the Motor Vehicle Act specifically provides for restriction of movement of motor vehicles. However, NGT can only be issued invoked when the acts given in its Schedule 1 are the acts under which the order has been issued. Those are the Environment Act and Air Act. As this order is not issued under those acts, neither it could be issued under those acts. It had to be issued under the Motor Vehicles Act. It would not be covered under the NGT's jurisdiction.
Are you done, petitioner?
Yeah.
Respondent, do you have any rebuttal? You are on mute right now. You can just unmute yourself.
Apologies. Indeed, as my learned counsel mentioned that the said impugned policy has not been passed under any of the acts mentioned in Schedule 1 of the National Green Tribunal Act 2010. However, the policy has been passed under the sections mentioned in, as the counsel earlier stated, in the Air Prevention and Control of Pollution Act and Environment Protection Act. So also it has a statutory backing. And also the NGT has jurisdiction in all civil cases relating to environment, which falls under the purview of Article 21 of the Constitution, here being the right to live in dignity in a pollution-free environment, air and water, etc. So,
Are you done?
Yeah, I think it's okay. It's done.
Your ladyship, do you have any questions to ask to the participants?
No. I ask in between only. I don't give a point. Okay.
Thank you.
Good, good. It was a good one.
Both participants.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
A token of appreciation. And you may leave the room. Thank you.
Final round is judged by Geeta Luthra, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Wow, amazing.
Thank you.
She's brilliant. She's brilliant. I've seen her in coaching. She exactly knows that where the party will go wrong is her forte. She knows where the other party will go wrong.
It's a question on that only to make them go down that road then.
Yeah, exactly, exactly. The point is sometimes there is someone who knows their own positives. Okay, I'm good at this. And there are very few people who knows, okay, the other person is
bad at this.
And that is something which is very interesting to know. That you already know that what the other party will be going wrong at. Okay, let's start. Okay.
There have been a lot of mishap. We lost Irfan, but Irfan Khan, you know.
Yeah, this year is a bit of sad year.
Yeah.
And it doesn't feel like that it is even going somewhere. Matlab end bhi to nahi ho raha hai. Pata nahi chal raha din kahan. Like the weekends and the weekdays all are seen. I mean, this is a very challenging year as per if you see mental health, because if you are sitting at continuously at one place or doing same things every day,
yes,
can really affect your mental health.
Yes,
because brain is also a machine and it keeps working all the time. Wo choti si problem kab itni badi ho jayegi ki aapko lagega ki no, now it will end my life. I mean, I think this might be one of the reasons for Sushant Singh also.
Yes, ma'am.
Because there must be problems, obviously. Problems to sabki life ka hi part hai. But then, I don't know, he must have taken advice or something.
And ma'am, how desperate would he have been that he used a curtain, his own curtain, to hang himself from the fan?
And to be very honest, I feel that living is less painful than ending your life in this way. I mean, this needs a lot of guts. Because chaku se aapko halki si ungli pe bhi lag jati hai na, so you feel that, arey mujhe to lag gayi. So doing and hurting your own self needs a lot more courage than living ki chalo yaar jo ho raha hai theek hai. I don't know what like mental status he must have been. It is really sad. And I think this is also a very bad message for the society. Because just this year... Tell me.
Ma'am, just a mere question. Like it's
a
matter of knowledge. So just I can gather
please. Yeah, I'm always open to discussions. Yeah, tell me.
Ma'am, in Supreme Court nowadays, many... petitions were going on not to take fees of private colleges during the semester which is not operating. So, like, what do you think? Like, what is the ultimatum of that? Whether we are going to proceed towards the, like, yes, that the private colleges are not going to take it, or like it is no, they are going to take it.
This situation is very tricky. I understand that fees are very high and it is useless to pay when you are not going and studying. But then if we see private colleges have faculties to maintain as well, and private jobs anyways cause a toll on you. So if you will not going to pay the fees, someone else will going to lose upon the money they might have got for their families. So yes, it is their fundamental right. It is a question of their fundamental right also. Then Article 19(1)(g) will come into play. So it's like, it's a tricky situation. Like both the parties are correct at different angles. One is standing at 6 and the other is standing at 9. So if you see from whichever angle, I think there has to be like, they can cut short the fees, of course.
Yes, ma'am.
But negating the entire fees can be like really a big troll. I don't think that should be even allowed.
Aryaman, because we will be waiting for 4 more minutes. Agar,
sure. No worries at all.
If it comes, to buddy.
Tell me if you all have any doubts. Let's discuss some good legal topics nowadays. So, the entire legal system is like scattered all over the place.
Yes, ma'am. And like I have asked one of the advocates just few days before. He's a practicing advocate of Supreme Court, and I questioned him that whether we are restricting our litigation career to a certain limit in this period of pandemic. So he was saying that if you look, it is like both side of coin. If you take it that restricting, we are restricting. We are concerned about only the urgent matters. And if you say we are broadening, so yes, we are broadening because nowadays we can carry out online mediations and online arbitrations. Like when FMC is over there, it's more easier to shift.
See, this is a very good time to strengthen our mediation system, which is very weak, but still mediation is so important. Because nowadays, if you see the temperament of people is so high that small, small issues become big fight. So I think this is a good time to work upon the mediation part. But then I think, see, if it is coming virtually, then it will be always in a restricted form only. Virtually cannot be all open.
Yes.
So like virtually, the judge might take only 15-20 cases. Sometimes there will be internet issue also that the judge might also not sit. Though it happens otherwise also that judge might go on a holiday. District court to aise hi chalte hain. But this is more like the people are not prepared for it mentally also. And there is obviously lack of infrastructure.
Ma'am, what is the situation of pandemic in your region specifically?
Actually, I have just now traveled from Delhi back. So I got tested. So I am fine. And in Madhya Pradesh, there are cases. Up to every state is having cases.
So like when you came back...
It is still under control. Yeah.
When you came back, it was a 14 days of quarantine you have to be.
Yeah, I am still in quarantine. It will be getting over on 18th. So it's strict quarantine, all the tests have been done, everything is fine. Yeah. See, you have to be like visible also that you have to follow the rules, otherwise no one can help. If I'm not staying in quarantine, the government cannot come to my house and make me stay in quarantine. You have to have that kind of legit idea that yes, you are not allowed to affect other people's life in this year. Because this is a serious year. And see, you have to take coronavirus seriously and risk everything goes at backseat this year. I mean, then now you don't have to worry about anything in life because after corona only everything will happen, whatever will happen. So like you can just chill also. Life is supposed to be taken on a lighter note.
Petitioner Council, are we audible to you?
Hello.
Yes.
With the pleasure and permission of this honorable court, may the council introduce itself.
Yeah, go ahead.
Much obliged, your lordship. Standing before the court is Komal Mittal, the counsel for petitioner.
Wait.
Yeah,
you are
not
allowed to take your name and all.
Mentioned in the rule.
My apologies.
C15. Yeah.
Okay.
It's
my apologies.
Petitioner's
lordship.
Yeah. Just go ahead with the facts.
Thank you.
Just go ahead with the facts.
For petition.
Not in.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sorry to interrupt you, P15. You were trying to join from two devices. Is it that?
No.
Fine. You may proceed.
Statement of facts. The Republic of Gotham is located in Southeast Asia. The Wakanda is a state located in northern part of Republic of Gotham. Over the past few years, there have been increasing reports of extremely dangerous air quality levels in Wakanda. The Wakanda government introduced the Green Wakanda policy for the month of January 2020. The policy puts restrictions on the number of days an individual may use their motor vehicles to commute. It states that an individual is only permitted to use their motor vehicles for 10 days in a month, and any deviation from the same will lead to heavy fines. Those commuting from the neighboring states for work are also subjected to this policy, and they are not allowed to use their motor vehicles for more than 10 days in a month. The Wakanda government decided to extend the application of the policy from 1 month to the period of 2 years, till January 2022 or until further notice. The announcement made by the Chief Minister of Wakanda creates waves all across the country of Gotham. Many stakeholders, including the industrialists and businessmen from non-essential goods and services sector, oppose the policy. The extension decision also resulted in many citizens opposing the policy on the ground that it curbed the fundamental liberties and thus could not stand in longer run. However, the Wakanda government refused to roll back the extension owing to the environmental concerns. Keeping in mind the strong opposition to the extension of Green Wakanda policy and the active protest against the same, the Fundamental Liberties Group, who are the registered society working towards upholding the fundamental liberties for the citizens.
Okay. I am thorough with the facts. Just come to your statement of issues.
Much obliged, my lord. Statement of issues. First, yeah, whether the petition filed by the Fundamental Liberties Group is maintainable in the Honorable High Court of Wakanda. Second issue is whether the Green Wakanda policy is constitutionally valid. Extension of it.
Now listen to my Now listen to my question. So why have you come to this court? Why do you think this court has jurisdiction? Why didn't you go to NGT for this? You should have gone to NGT.
My lord, according to Article 226, the High Court has the power to issue the writs for the enforcement of fundamental rights, and PIL can be filed in the High Court.
Yeah, but in this PIL, it looks like a reasonable restriction. What if it gets rejected here? Then what will you do? You haven't already exhausted all your rights by not going to NGT. You should have gone to NGT first.
My lord, my counsel insisted that the counsel wants to appear before the High Court, and if the petition got rejected and we had to file for the appeal, we would be going to the Supreme Court for this matter.
But you will not be going, you couldn't start with NGT, you will be going for this to Supreme Court. Sounds good, okay. Go ahead. Yeah, start with your issues.
May the council put forward the arguments for the issues. Arguments for issue one. Issue one, whether the writ petition filed by the Fundamental Liberties Group is maintainable in High Court of Wakanda. A. The petition filed in public interest and therefore maintainable as PIL. To invoke the writ jurisdiction of High Court, it is not necessary that the fundamental right must have been actually infringed. A threat to the same would be significant. According to the doctrine of reasonable apprehension, this honorable court may interfere directly in the said case.
How many PIL are there? And there what are is the nature six. Of your PIL?
There are 5 PILs which the High Court and the Supreme Court can issue. And the PIL, my client is seeking is... It is for the mandamus.
It is mandamus, are you sure?
Yes.
Okay, go ahead.
Applying the doctrine of reasonable apprehension, this honorable court may interfere directly in said case. The most fundamental right of an individual is his right to life and personal liberty. If an administrative decision is not reasonable, the basis for the decision surely calls for the most anxious scrutiny according to the principle of anxious scrutiny. Thus, the petition filed before the Honorable Court is maintainable. B. The writ petition is independent of existing alternate remedy. The existence of alternate remedy is no bar for the enforcement of fundamental rights under Article 226 of the Constitution. In spite of availability of alternate remedy, the court may exercise its writ jurisdiction in at least the petitions where the petitioner seeks enforcement of fundamental rights. Thus, the petitioner humbly submits that writ petition is maintainable as existence of alternate remedy is not a bar. C, the writ petition is maintainable where there is infringement of fundamental rights. If there is an infringement or violation of fundamental rights conferred by Part 3 of the Constitution, the writ petition can be invoked as per the case T.S. Basappa versus Razappa, AIR 1954, Supreme Court 440. D, the constitutionality is being challenged. The policy is in derogation of Article 13, 19 and 21 of the Constitution, as it is an arbitrary policy. As per Article 13, Clause 2, the state can't make any law inconsistent with Part 3 of the Constitution containing the fundamental rights. Power of judicial review is also provided under Article 13, Clause 2 to the High Courts, which can declare a law unconstitutional.
It is not inconsistent with Part 3. How it is inconsistent with Part 3? It is a reasonable restriction.
There is no reason provided for the restriction by the Wakanda government. As
they have. It is the air is so polluted and they have statistics.
The air is polluted, but they have not provided any reason why they are extending the policy for 2 years. Why not for 1 year? And why are they allowing only for 10 days? Why can't they allow it for 25 days, 15 days, 20 days?
No, because it is... We had lockdown 1.0, then we felt it's 2.0, then now we are in this scenic beauty of 5.0. So it is the need of the situation. So they must have felt that 2 years may lead to drop down in the pollution. What do you think?
But it also curbs the rights of the people who are not able to do their jobs and who can't avail the facility of education and who are not able to do any work or commute for their essential services. And
we are having virtual moot court. Why won't they study virtually? Studies are not being practiced. And plus they will use public vehicle.
Public vehicle is not sufficient for the population of Wakanda, as it is, it can't accommodate the population, which is huge. It is 1.4 billion people.
Okay, go ahead.
Second issue is whether the extension of Green Wakanda policy is constitutionally valid. First, violation of Article 13. The main objective of Article 13 is to secure paramountancy of the Constitution, especially with regard to fundamental rights. Green Wakanda policy is arbitrary, as the government didn't specify why they are extending it for 2 years. And what is the reason of allowing only 10 days? And it is a violation of Article 19.
This is not a violation of Article 13. Go ahead.
Article 19 is the right to freedom, which is provided to all the citizens of Wakanda. It is a fundamental right as per the Constitution. Right to movement of the citizens is contained under Article 19, Clause 1, Subclause D, which can't be restricted by the government if there is no reasonableness of the restriction.
I'm sure it is violation of Article 21, because it is not a blanket ban. Article 21 would have been infringed when it would have been a blanket ban situation. This is a reasonable restriction. It is just a restriction for some time.
I think it is a reasonable restriction, as it doesn't include the non-essential goods and services and the movement for these
restriction, right? You agree to this, that this is a reasonable restriction?
This is not a reasonable restriction as per the government, as the proper reasons are not provided by the government. And
no, they are.
Right to life includes right to live with human dignity, which also includes freely moving about and mixing with fellow human beings.
But right to life also include the right over fresh air, na, which they are not getting. So anyways, both are right to life only. Both are coming under right to life only, na.
I agree.
The right to have fresh air, the right to move, both are a part of right to life. So, which right is bigger? And which right you will avail first? Right to have a fresh air to breathe or right to move?
right to life includes both, I agree, and right to air is a superior one, but my clients and I want to state that the restriction put by the government is not reasonable and people are facing huge problems.
Sorry to interrupt you.
Yeah.
Please conclude your statements first. Your time is out.
Okay. But you said just now that the right to air is superior one. You agreed to it.
But how can the people live if they have not earned so much in the 10 days or if they can't go
but
for
you
their...
But you only said right to air is superior one. Think about it.
But one right can't be curtailed for the other right. As both are the fundamental rights under Article
11. State your prayer. What is your prayer? What are you asking?
In the light of the issues raised, argument advanced and authorities cited, the counsel for the petitioner humbly prays before the Honorable Court that the writ filed is maintainable in the court of law and the extension of Green Wakanda policy is invalid and unconstitutional and to order restrain and to pass an order restraining respondents in proceeding with the policy.
Okay.
And any other order that the Honorable Court may deem fit in the interest of equity, justice and good conscience. And all these acts, the counsel for the petitioner shall duty bound forever pray, all of which is humbly prayed by the counsel of petitioner. That concludes my submission. It is a pleasure presenting before the court.
Okay, thank you.
Counsel for the side of respondent.
May please the Honorable Court.
Yeah.
May please the Honorable Court. Much obliged. Myself, counsel, is present before this Honorable Court representing the respondent in this case. If your honor is well versed with the facts, then the counsel would seek permission to proceed with the arguments.
Just tell me that where in fact it is mentioned that it is necessary to extend the restrictions for 2 years. Why the restrictions are being extended for 2 years directly?
Okay. Your Honor, this policy has already been experimented for a month. It has been experimented for the month of January 2020. And the government has clearly given a report. The report, it compares the air quality index of 2 months. That is the month of January 2019 and January 2020. And there is a very good improvement in the air quality index. Keeping this point in mind, Your Honor, in the state of Wakanda, there is a huge concern of vehicular pollution. And since there is a very good improvement in the air quality index in the January 2020, it has been extended, Your Honor.
Directly for 2 years?
Your Honor, Article 21 of the Constitution clearly says right to life and right to health. States about a person's right to life and right to health. So keeping that in mind, Your Honor, since the air pollution is a big concern, health is a big concern, it has been extended, Your Honor.
And right to movement,
and
that is also a part
even
of
though
it.
Even though it is even yes, but then the government has given various measures, provided for various measures, Your Honor. It has clearly stated that the citizen can use the vehicle whenever necessary. During an emergency, it can be used. And for the movement of essential things, it can be used. It has allowed those who cannot avail this environment-friendly things, they can work from home. Various measures have been provided by the state government, Your Honor.
Okay, come to your advanced arguments. You can come to your advanced arguments. There.
Okay. Much obliged.
Yeah.
Your Honor, the first issue to be dealt with is whether the petition filed by the Fundamental Liberties Group, FLG, is maintainable in the Honorable High Court of Wakanda. It is, Your Honor, it is humbly submitted that the petition filed by the Fundamental Liberty Group before this court is not maintainable. the council would like to establish the same in the further arguments, because of, there are two important reasons here. The council would like to point that there is no reasonable ground in this petition, and the policy and the decision, the grain walk and the policy decision introduced by the government is a policy decision of the government. Okay, and which is beyond court's ambit to review. In the following arguments, the council would like to establish the same. Okay, Your Honor, Article 226 of the Constitution, under Article 226 of the Constitution, a petitioner can file a petition only if the legal rights or the constitutional rights of or the general public right is violated at large. Your Honor, Lord Dennings in R versus Peddington has clearly, has rightly observed that if a citizen wants to challenge a law, this citizen must first show that he or she is experiencing a harm as a result of that law. This means that people cannot challenge law just on the principle of the matter or because they think that the laws might harm them, harm them or other people. Laws.
Because see, we are in a lockdown, we are facing so much problems sitting inside. There is mental health issue, we have to go out for groceries,
but
students
then,
have
even
to study,
during,
they need fresh air, everything is there. It is a basic.
Even Your Honor, even during the lockdown, the government is providing for various measures. For students, the online classes are provided, free webinars are provided, free courses are provided, Your Honor. And even for the emergency, the movement is allowed, Your Honor. Now even the interstate movements are allowed, Your Honor. The same thing, even here, the government is provided for various measures, Your Honor. And in this case, Your Honor, there is no question of violation of any legal right or constitutional right. And there is no harm which is shown. There is no harm caused to any individual, Your Honor, in this case. And the probability that the harm would be caused is not there, Your Honor. And in detail about it shall be dealt in the second issue, Your Honor. The council further... No. Some more
there
points.
There is still left.
Policy decision. Okay. Your Honor, the council further would like to bring you to your notice that the green walker policy introduced by the government is a policy decision. In Akhil Bharat Goseva Sun versus State of Andhra Pradesh, the court held that the policy decision of the government cannot be interfered with or struck down merely on certain factual disputes in the matter. It is not open to the court to strike down such decision until and unless a serious and grave error is found on the part of the central government or state government. Your Honor, here there is no question of grave error in the policy. Further, Your Honor, in State of Madhya Pradesh versus Narmada Bachao Andolan, it was held that court cannot strike down a policy decision taken by the state government merely because it feels that another decision would have been fairer or wiser or mere scientific or logical, Your Honor. And Your Honor, as already stated by the council, there are various measures provided here. So the council would humbly submit that it is very clear that the petitioner is a busy body and has filed this frivolous petition, and the petitioner has no locus standi, and for the reasons already stated, it can be said that the petition is not maintainable.
Why if they don't have a locus standi? Their fundamental right is being infringed. They have a locus standi.
No, Your Honor, as
Article 21. Under Article 21, under Article 14, their fundamental rights is being infringed.
But it is a reasonable restriction, Your Honor. And
for
as
two
already
years.
Stated this,
at a stretch for the, 2 years, it is a reasonable restriction.
The council will come to that point in the second issue, Your Honor. If Your Honor is well satisfied with the arguments of the first issue, the council will proceed with the second issue.
Yes, come to the second issue.
Okay. Okay, Your Honor, the second issue to be dealt with is whether the extension of the green walk under policy is constitutionally valid. It is humbly submitted before this Honorable High Court that the extension of the green walk under policy is not constitutionally valid. The council would like to establish the same because of the following important reasons. Your Honor, there are various fundamental rights established by the Constitution of Republic of Gotham. But the council would like to highlight these fundamental rights of the citizen under the constitution are not absolute. There are various reasonable restrictions under Article 19 Clause 6 which can be imposed on fundamental rights. The council would further like to highlight that under Article 19 Clause 6, one major reasonable restriction can be in the interest of general public, keeping in mind their health, moral, and safety. And that is, in short, can be said, this reasonable restriction is for the welfare of the citizen, Your Honor. So it can be clearly concluded the reasonable restriction which has been imposed by the Wakanda state government in this policy on an individual, that an individual is only permitted to use their vehicle for 10 days in a month, and any deviation from the same will lead to heavy fines, is in the interest of general public, keeping in mind their health, moral, and safety. And it comes within the concept of reasonable restriction in the Constitution, Your Honor. And you're on.
It doesn't look like a reasonable restriction. It looks like that it is an arbitrary to increase the time limit for 2 years at this stretch. How can it be for 2 years, and how can you be so sure that after 2 years again people will go out? Then after 2 years people will start moving more and more. Obviously, if they are being crabbed like this, when they'll be freed, they'll roam around.
When the Chief Minister of Wakanda, Mr. Ned Stark, extended the policy, he has clearly mentioned it is either for the until 2 years or until further notice, which means that if the improvement takes place much earlier, then the policy might be removed, Your Honor. And Your Honor, all this has already been experimented, and environmental lobby has considered it as a masterstroke, Your Honor. So, since it has already been experimented for a month, Wakanda state government would not like to make any changes regarding it. It would like to continue with the same. And the chief minister clearly stated that he would try to bring in more measures. More efforts would be made. Similarly, development will be made, Your Honor. Various other measures will be brought in, Your Honor. Your Honor, as the Constitution of Republic of Gotham gives every citizen a fundamental right along with reasonable restriction, as already stated. Similarly, the very Constitution gives every citizen the duty to protect the environment. Article 47 and 48A under Directive of State Policy of the Constitution puts an obligation on the state to protect the environment. And Your Honor, the state...
Will Limitation Act work upon this reasonable restriction? Will it be effective? Because reasonable restriction also has to be for a limited time. Now, if tomorrow the government said that for next 3 years the country is under lockdown, then what we will do? Corona cases are increasing every day.
But there is no...
What if the government decides that 3 years bandi rahega desh? Everyone sit at home.
That is not done, Your Honor, in this policy. It is just one restriction that for 10 days people are allowed to move their vehicle. And various other measures are given, Your Honor.
We are also given, we are doing moot court virtually. What else? We are studying here. We are doing exchange of ideas. There are so many online courses. But what if the government decides tomorrow, man ki baat mein bol de wo, the country will be shut down for 3 years at a stretch.
Respondent, petitioner, try to understand the point of your ladyship and try to conclude your point as far as possible, as soon as possible, because you are already late by 5 minutes.
Come to your prayer.
Your Honor. Your Honor, the council would again state that it is a reasonable restriction, and even the DPSP fundamental duty, even the citizen has a fundamental duties, Your Honor, under 51A.
So it is our duty also to crap Corona.
Yeah, it is also.
I think we should be under lockdown for 3 years. Next 3 years,
this lockdown is for our own safety, Your Honor, for the health of the own citizen, Your Honor.
So sitting inside home, your health will be fine. You don't need a walk.
Your Honor, the lockdown is done. The government sees that if there are any reduce in the cases, and if there are reduce in the cases, accordingly it has introduced into red zone, green zone, and then certain movements will be allowed there. Similarly, Your Honor, here. Your Honor.
Tell. Okay, yes, you can cover up.
Sorry. Okay.
Okay. Please conclude.
If your honor is if your honor is well satisfied with the argument, the council will move with the
yes,
prayer.
Yes. Conclude it with your prayer. I've already read your prayer.
Therefore, in the light of the issues raised, arguments advanced, and the authority cited, it is humbly prayed before this honorable court that this honorable court may dismiss the petition filed by the petitioner.
Just outright dismiss it. Okay.
Humbly pray before this honorable court. Yeah.
Okay. Let's see if there is any rebuttal questions and go ahead.
Petitioner counsel, do you have any rebuttals from your
side? Yes, I have a rebuttal.
You may proceed. You have only 2 minutes. Try to be as fast as possible.
Your Honor, my fellow counsel said the extension of Green Wakanda policy by the Wakanda government is a policy decision and hence can't be reviewed under the Article 226. But it is not so. According to Article 13, Clause 3, law includes any ordinance, order, bylaws, rules, regulations, notifications, customs or usages having the territory of India, the force of law. According to Article 13, Clause 2, the Article 13, Clause 2 clearly prohibits the making of any law by the state which takes away or abridges the rights conferred by Part 3 of the Constitution. In the extent of such a law being made, the same shall be declared void to the extent of the contravention as per State of Punjab versus Dalbir Singh case 2012 AIR Supreme Court 1040.
That's it. Thank you. Respondent, counsel, do you have any sir rebuttal?
No, sir.
Okay, thank you. Your ladyship, do you want to ask any question from the participants?
No.
Thank you.
Much obliged.
Much obliged.
Participants, thank you. You may leave.
It was a pleasure.
Okay.
Yes.
Thank you, participants.
Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you.
You may please leave the room. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, let's come to the points marking system.
Ma'am, I hope 2 points came new. They were really interesting. One of was that state versus Narmada Bachao Andolan, where the policy which was discussed. And secondly, the green zone, red zone part, which was also clarified.
Yes, that's why I said, yeah, it's good. I actually was waiting to hear that zone part from such a long time. Yes, so finally, I thought that thoda instigate karna padega ki koi thoda aur soche. So I confused him thoroughly so that he can at least he will come up with something new.
Yes.
Because it's already fourth round and we need something new. We want to hear something new now.
Petitioner counsel, you can begin with your arguments.
Thank you, sir. Greetings to the honorable bench and the organizers. May it please this Honorable Court, this is the counsel appearing on behalf of the petitioners in the case of Fundamental Liberties Group versus State of Wakanda. The petitioners have approached this Honorable Court under Article 226 by the way of a public interest litigation. Your ladyship, does your ladyship require a brief perusal of the facts?
Why did you came in Article 226 and not 227? What is the difference between Article 226 and 227?
Your ladyship, Article 226 is the power of the High Court to issue writs, and whereas Article 227 is the power of superintendence of the High Court over the other courts.
Okay. And why did you go to NGT?
Your ladyship, it is a registered society working for the upholdment of the fundamental rights of the people.
Okay, but it looks like a reasonable restriction. It doesn't look like an infringement of fundamental right.
Your Ladyship, there's a clear infringement of fundamental rights under article mentioned under Article 19, 14 and 21. And this will be elaborately dealt by the Council in the second limb of the argument. The first limb refers to whether the present petition is maintainable under law, for which the Council would be proving it in four limbs. So, Your Ladyship, do you need the elaborate explanation now, or can I explain it at a later point of time when I'm coming to the second issue?
You can start with your statement of issues. I'm thorough with that.
Much obliged, Your Ladyship. Your Ladyship, there are two issues in the present case. The first being whether the petition filed by the FLG, that is the Fundamental Liberties Group, is maintainable under law. And second is whether the extension of Green Wakanda policy is constitutionally valid. Your Ladyship, for the first issue, the Council will be proving in three limbs that the present petition must be made maintainable by the Honorable Court. For the first limb, the petitioner likes to contend that the instant petition is bona fide in nature. And for the same, the Council refers to the case of People's Union for Democratic Rights and Others versus Union of India. Please refer to para 4 of the memorial submitted on behalf of the petitioners. In that, the Honorable Court held that public interest litigation is a cooperative and collaborative effort by the petitioner, the state of public authority and the judiciary to secure observance of constitutional and basic human rights, and also the benefits and privileges upon the poor, downtrodden and vulnerable society. Your Ladyship, the court must assist in the realization of the constitutional objectivities. So here in the present case, the petitioner have filed this instant petition against the curbing of fundamental rights by the extension of the Wakanda Green policy. Your Ladyship, with respect to the second limb, Article 226 of the Constitution can be invoked to injustice and to secure fundamental rights. In the present case, there's been clear infringement of fundamental rights because a clear blunted differentiation between the non-essential sectors and essential sectors has been given by the government, which will be elaborated in the second limb of the arguments. And for instance, the Council would like the Lord Ladyship to refer to para 5 of the memorial, in which the Council would have quoted the case of Dwarka Nath versus income tax officer, in which the court held that Article 226 of the Constitution is a wide power vested upon the High Court, and that it can sought to reach out injustice with it, and also violation of any fundamental right would be is a great substantial question of law, is the third part of the first issue. So violation of here a substantial question of law, the High Court or any constitutional court can invoke its jurisdiction when there is a substantial question of law is present. Here in the present case...
Wait. You are saying that this is an infringement of Article 21. So, right to life, under right to life is a very wide topic. So, yes, right to fresh air is also a fundamental right under right to life.
Yes,
and right to movement is also. So, which right you will keep above? Like, which is a prioritized right according to you? Right to fresh air or right to movement?
In the present case, the Council humbly contends that right to livelihood must be prioritized because the people living in Wakanda are being subjected to the policy of work from home. And it is in the annexure B, it has been certain industries have been clearly left out from the annexure B, that is mainly construction sites. So people being the manager or supervisors in the construction sites, they are not being led to work and earn for their life, which in fact infringes their right to livelihood. And secondly, also media industry, especially your ladyship, journalism is a very progressive industry, and without journalism, there cannot be anything in the present scenario of the world. And news is very important. And if they are not allowed to work, it also infringes their own right to livelihood as well as their right to practice their own profession. And also,
but we are also under lockdown. The same situations and the same problems are there. So what we should do?
Can I compare and talk to your ladyship, like compare with India's
scenario
as well? Your ladyship, in India, the scenario is completely different because we are suffering from a pandemic, which is a global pandemic, as well as it is pertinent to know that we are affected by a viral disease. Also, even in the present case, restrictions have been given by the government, but it has been given a severe lockdown was imposed only for a month, only from March 25 till June 8. After June 8, the government started taking measures for unlocking measures. That is, they've started certain retailing businesses to open, and they've also started progressively for their economy to build. However, even in such circumstances, media was not one of the industries which the government did not take away their right from. So here in the present case, this extension is for period of 2 years or more. A perusal of para 3 of the Mood proposition would provide that Mr. Ned Stark announced this due to the success of the Green Wakanda policy for the month of January 2020. He had extended the policy for 2 years or more. So here the word more is pretty ambiguous, and in such cases, the right to livelihood must be given a priority because of the fact that there's an ambiguity in the said announcement.
Okay, come to your second.
Much obliged. Your ladyship, with respect to the second issue, the council would like to prove that the extension of the Green Wakanda policy is constitutionally invalid. For the same, the council would like to invoke the Article 14, violation of Article 14. So, your ladyship, Article 14, it is a well-settled rule that no government or government instruction can violate Article 14 or any other provision of the constitution, as constitution is the highest law of the land, and it has been held in the case of Devdutt versus Union of India. Please refer to para 14 of the memorial. And in the same case, in instant case, Wakanda has clearly created an unreasonable classification between the essential and the non-essential sectors, which is a clear violation of Article 14. At this instance, the respondent council might claim that it passes the test of reasonable classification, which brings us to the test of principle of intelligible differentia and a reasonable nexus. Here in the present case, there is no intelligible differentia because they have been clearly classified in a discriminate manner, and the council would now like to state why. Firstly, your ladyship, as the council earlier said, para 2 clearly stated that the only reason as to why this Wakanda Green policy was introduced was to curb air pollution, and that is why they have restricted the usage of automobiles. Here in the present case, at one point they are restricting the usage of automobiles. On this other hand, a perusal of the annexure B, point 5 would provide that they are allowing industrial establishment. Your ladyship, it is a known fact that even industrial establishment will lead to a greater amount of air pollution than the automobile usage. So in the present case, the government may try...
Why have you applied legitimate expectation? How your come ladyship, a doctrine of legitimate expectation holds true in this scenario?
The council would like to answer the question. Your ladyship, yes. Doctrine of legitimate expectation is the expectation upon the government to honor its own policies as well as its own promises. Here in the present case, the government of Wakanda, by violating the provisions of the constitution under Article 14, 19 and 21, is clearly led to the has not honored the doctrine of legitimate expectation, and that is why the council had put in the memorial.
But the law which is being implied doesn't have any malafide intention. Doesn't look like it has any malafide intention.
Because they have
presented data also from January 2019 to January 2020, depicting that, I think 18 to 19 or 19 to 20, depicting that the most of the air pollution is due to vehicles. So, I don't think that this doctrine is...
Can I please answer the question?
Yes.
Your ladyship, at this point, the council would like to state that judicial review of a policy can be invoked if the policy is said to be unconstitutional, deviates the principal provisions of the act and regulations, if the delegatee has acted beyond its power of delegation, and if the executive policy is contrary to the statutory or larger policy. And it was stated in the case of Delhi Development Authority, which is Joint Action Committee, and I have mentioned in para 26 of the memorial. In the present case, the executive order is clearly unconstitutional.
With due permission of your ladyship.
Yes.
Counsel, can you please conclude your statements as you are running out of time?
Okay.
Much obliged, much obliged.
Come to your prayer.
I would answer this question first, Your Ladyship. Oh. With respect to Your Ladyship's question, malafide intention is not the only reason as to why a judicial review of policy must be shown. Even if a decision is shown to be patently arbitrary or discriminatory or malafide, in the case of state of Madhya Pradesh, which is Nandlal Jaiswal, para 24 of the memorial, I would have stated the same. So even if it's arbitrary or discriminatory, judicial review is allowed and thus this policy must be extension must be taken away. Also, in the present case, Article 19, as I always said, is also violated because of the fact that certain industries.
So according to you, the people who are breaking the lockdown in present in India scenario, that the people who are breaking the lockdown maybe because they are not getting good job or they don't have money or they are doing means they are lacking the basic facilities. So that is the correct thing to do. I mean, because the government is not having proper measures, it's arbitrary. So the people, whatever they are reacting to, is good enough, according to you.
Can you please?
Are you justifying it?
Can I please rephrase the question so that the judge might understand the question. Your Ladyship, you just asked me if I could justify the activities of the citizens not following the orders of the government. Am I right?
Yes.
Your Ladyship, in no way the counsel for the petitioners could justify for the breach of law committed by certain citizens, Your Ladyship. And that is why we as petitioners, as a group of people, have come before this Honorable Court to take away, to nullify the extension of the Green Wakanda policy. Because, Your Ladyship, at this point, the very policy extension raises many questions.
With and your permission, counsel, sorry to interrupt you. Please conclude.
Much obliged. At this point, the council like to conclude that the present petition is not is maintainable under law because it's bona fide in nature and Article 226 must be invoked to secure justice and to secure fundamental rights. Secondly, the present extension of Green Wakanda policy is arbitrary in nature and it violates Article 14, 19 and 21 and judicial review must be and a policy of such nature must be subjected to judicial review and this instance the certain discrepancies in the policy is also a very questionable, namely the government does not mention any measures as to how to check on the people who have been violating such laws. Like they say that or they have a restriction on number of days being 10. But how the government intend to identify council. Whether
okay.
Much obliged. The council like to move to prayer if your ladyship accepts.
It's okay. I have read your prayer. Time is over.
Much obliged. It was a great arguing before this Honorable Court. Thank you, Your Ladyship, for your graceful time.
Counsel, from the side of respondent, you may put your arguments.
Just a minute. I'm just lost.
Counsel, just wait for a few minutes.
Yes, please. Just wait for a few minutes. Okay. Respondent 390, right? Yeah, start.
Shall we begin, ma'am?
Yes.
Lady, may I permit, may I proceed on the behalf of the state? Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible. You may begin with your arguments.
Barack Obama, the 44th president of the United States, said, if we don't tackle the climate change, then our future generation won't be able to debate on it because they will be busy tackling. And I bet that the petitioner will also agree that the air pollution is a grave problem and it is slowly taking us to a painful death. Now, coming to the petition, which has been filed, starting with the first issue of maintainability, the respondent humbly submits that, firstly, that the petitioner lacks the locus. The reason for that is, though the court in the recent modern times has extended the ambit of the locus standi, that any public spirited person can come to the court. But here, we respectfully submit that the petitioner's motives are quite cloudy because the reason being the policy was initially rolled on in January 2020 and the rules then and now on the time of extension are the same. If the petitioner claims that there was an infringement of fundamental rights, that the same existed then as it did now. So it's, and the reasons go and explain why it didn't approach then, but it is approaching now, when due to the extension, the policy has gained huge publicity, not in just in Bangkala, the whole nation of Kotham. The second question which the respondent raises is that the court, which we respectfully submit, that the court must not interfere with administrative powers of the executive. And I would like to link to part 1.2 of my memorial with that of 2.1. In 1.2, I state that this is purely an administrative matter, which is by which the government has brought the policy. And the government very respectfully agrees that the court has the power of judicial review. But the government submits that it must not be exercised here because the reasons referred in 2.1 are so convincing that the whole scheme of this policy which the government has brought in is well within the constitutional parameters. Starting with the first point, that it is duty of the state to provide a clean environment to all its citizens. In the case of M.C. Mehta versus Union of India, the Supreme Court had held that the right to clean environment is a basic fundamental right. Also, in the various judgments stated below to it on page number 13, the court has held that it is a duty of the state to provide that right to those, to its citizens. Also, there are many provisions like part 4 of the Constitution in which Article 48 states that the state shall endeavor to protect and foster the environment. And also, on page number 14, there are many statutes and international obligations which have been referred, which show the intent of the legislature of the country and the whole global community who are striving to save the environment. And the state is bound to direct its policies in that direction and make laws under such provisions.
So but the state is not bound to extend it directly for 2 years. I mean, you need to have very practical and logical grounds and preparation for the same also.
That would come under the next submission, which I'm going to make, under the garb of reasonable restrictions.
Okay, go ahead.
So till now, to sum up, I have told that the petitioner lacks the locus in the matter. Secondly, why the court must not interfere, because it is an administrative matter, and even being excised in judicial review administrative matter.
Excuse me, what are you saying? That the court has no jurisdiction to interfere?
No. I have even stated in the memorial that the respondent respectfully submits that the court has judicial review, and it is a basic structure of the Constitution as per the fundamental rights case, Keshwan and the Bharti. But when a policy is within the parameters of the Constitution, then I have stated here in the memorial, the division of powers, the Montesquieu division of powers, as stated in the footnote number 6, the court has held the judicial review must be limited. And if the government is acting within the parameters of the Constitution, the court must not interfere that this policy is right, this is wrong. That is the ambit of the executive.
So according to you, the CA and RC which is coming, so the court cannot interfere if it feels that any part is legal or illegal. The government can come out with it.
My lady, very respectfully, I would differentiate both. This is an administrative policy that has been brought by a means of a legislation. And it is, they both are different. There the court has to see if it is constitutional or not. Here the respondent is submitting that it is fulfilling the fundamental rights which it has to give to its citizens. Yeah, that thing is still cloudy.
I don't think this is an administrative policy. That means it can come out without the interference and the legality.
The judiciary can interfere. The judicial review can be exercised.
Judiciary is not interfering pro bono. The case has been submitted. The case has been filed here. The writ petition is filed. Judiciary is not interfering. The parties have come to the judiciary.
Yeah, I respectfully submit that the court must exercise the judicial review, but being on the part of counsel of the respondent, I submit that within the constitutional parameters, these reasons are satisfying for the judiciary to get satisfied that it is within the constitutional parameters and it must not interfere. So if you may permit, may I proceed?
Yes, yes. Come to your next issue.
On page 14 in part 2.2, of my submissions, I have stated various instances where the court itself has banned various activities under which it considered to be polluting. Like the court banned the use of harmful fuel in the NCT of Delhi, in the case of MC Mehta versus Union of India. In the Ganga pollution case, the court said that all the industries which are polluting the river must be shut. And to quote the strong words of the court, it had that we know it may lead to unemployment and loss of revenue, but the preservation of life, health and ecology are the most important thing and anything else. This is again the case of MC Mehta versus Union of India, famous as the Ganga pollution case. And in the case of Hanuman Boxman, the bench headed by Justice Chandrachud said that the government could not proceed by building an international airport because we have not taken care of the environmental procedures. So when the court has struck down so big policies on the ground that we have not following the environmental procedures, in the same here, this policy is comparatively less restrictive. We're just saying use your vehicle for 10 days from going for a home to your office. That's the only restriction. Comparatively, where judiciary has struck down big policies, citing the environment as the reason. Now, coming to the last, second last thing which I have left with, that is fundamental rights are not absolute. It is even enriched in the constitution, and even the court has accepted it in various judgments, like the modern.
But reasonable restrictions have been kept under strict parameters. Reasonable restrictions have to be reasonable enough. And do you think it is reasonable to extend this for 2 years at a stretch? Like if we decide to extend the lockdown for 3 years, cases are increasing of coronavirus also. So I think the government should then declare, according to you, 3 year lockdown. India will be locked down under 3 years.
So the case do have a very heavy weight on what's happening. And if in this case has to be differentiated with the coronavirus, because that is a medical situation and it will be done according to what happens, how many cases are increasing. Here we are dealing with pollution. And how it is reasonable, I'll just explain by applying the doctrine of proportionality to the same.
Okay, tell me. Yes.
So, as I stated, I have mentioned in page 16 and 17 of my memorial that the fundamental rights are subject to reasonable restrictions. Now, how I'll prove that the restrictions imposed by us are reasonable is by applying the test of proportionality. As envisaged by the court in the case Kutaswamy versus Union of India, the Adhar 5-judge bench, where Justice Chandrachud laid the 3 steps, that is, first, there must be legality. The state submits that it has made the policy under section 115, that means section 201 and 213.1 of the Motor Vehicles Act. Also, as stated by me earlier, that it is a fundamental right to a clean environment. So there exists legal framework under which the policy has been made. If my lady may so permit, may I just finish my arguments, because it's indicating that time is over.
Come to your prayer.
Sure.
Okay. What are you seeking from this court?
What I see from the court is that in light of the things the authority cited and in the light of the facts that the restrictions imposed by the policy are reasonable, and the aim the policy envisages is to protect and save the environment. So it doesn't deny fundamental rights to the citizen, rather it ensures and cements the same. So what we pray from the court is that the petition is not maintainable and it must not be entertained by the court. Alternatively, the court must dismiss the petition on the ground that the Green Book and the policy and its extension to the constitution. Arrest the case.
Okay.
Thank you.
Your ladyship, do you have any question to be asked?
You are currently on mute, petitioners. We weren't able to hear you.
No. One second. Just 1 second. Petitioner, counsel, do you have any rebuttal?
Yes, sir. Yes, I seek permission for the rebuttals, your ladyship.
Now you can proceed.
Yes.
Much obliged. Your ladyship, there are certain questions which I want the respondent counsel to answer. The first being, the government says that it imposes heavy fines, but the measures of the fine or what constitutes the heavy fine must be explained, because there is no guideline or there is no rules backing the Wakanda policy, and thus the respondent must answer the same. And also, the council really wants to know that whether this particular policy applies to every citizen irrespective of the status, because as a fact, it is that people belonging to higher public authorities, especially the chief minister or a commissioner, will need a convoy and they'll surely travel in a private vehicle. So if certain exemptions are being given to such people, why are they not mentioned in the policy? And firstly, the The respondent said that falls under reasonable exceptions and a doctrine of proportionality. However, for a doctrine of proportionality to be applied, in the case of Om Kumar versus Union of India, it was said that the decision maker must have arrived to his decision with his priorities and preparedness. Here, there is no priority or no preparedness because of the fact that the educational institutions are not mentioned from the exemption. So, does the respondent counsel want the students to not pursue the education or through any means to study because of this particular extension of the green policy, green Wakanda policy? Also, the fact that he had section 115 was taken upon reliance by the learned counsel. How was section 115? Just a minute, I will just one point. I'll conclude, Your Ladyship. Section 115 clearly says that the notification must be published in an official gazette by the state government. However, in the present case, there was no such notification published in the official gazette, which itself brings to the question that whether this policy is indeed a law. Only under Article 13, Clause 3, notification is a law. But here, notification in accordance with the must be published in an official gazette, and it was not in the present case. And I expect the respondent counsel to answer all these questions. Thank you, Your Ladyship, for the time.
Counsel, from the side of respondent, do you have any sir rebuttal? Do you have any sir rebuttal?
I have, sir.
You have. Yeah. Yes, you may proceed. Only you have 1 minute in your hand.
The petitioner cited various facts and various conditions. I would just like to state note one in the Moot proposition, which says that the participants are not allowed to assume extra facts to strengthen their case. And the petitioner had referred various facts which are not referred in the Moot proposition. Also, I would like to justify the two-year term by saying that in case of vehicles, there is a simple proportion. If you are running vehicles which are causing pollution, the environment will get polluted. And if you stop running them, the environment will not. That's the simple policy. And that's the simple ratio on which the policy is based. If you run vehicles, they will pollute. If you don't, they won't. So just the state says that run green vehicles. Use CNG. Use e-vehicles, which don't have zero emission. Just use them. And in that case, there's no difference between non-essential and essential. If non-essential are using green vehicles, there is no restriction at all. You use e-vehicles, you use battery vehicles, we won't stop you.
Counsel, thank you.
Okay.
And I'm sure hearing you.
None.
Thank you. Your Ladyship, do you have any question from the participants?
No.
No. Okay. Fine. Thank you, both the counsels. You may leave the room.
Thank you, Your Ladyship, and the organizers.
This is the Honorable High Court of Wakanda. And the present case is R-260. And the other party, the petitioner, is being absent. I request your ladyship to please proceed with an ex parte decree.
Yes. I agree to proceed with the ex parte and hear to what respondents have to say.
Thank you, Your Ladyship. Respondent counsel, you have the time. You can speak now.
Thank you. May it please this Honorable Court, this is the Advocate General appearing on behalf of the respondent in the case of Fundamental Liberties Group versus the State of Wakanda. May I state the jurisdiction invoked by the petitioner, Your Ladyship?
Yeah, go ahead.
The petitioner is invoking the writ jurisdiction, extraordinary writ jurisdiction of the High Court under Article 226. However, the respondent seeks permission to contend the maintainability of the petition. May I move on to the facts of the case?
Come to the issues. I am thorough with the facts.
Much obliged, Your Lordship. The first issue is whether the present petition filed by the petitioner is maintainable. The petition is not maintainable on the grounds that the petitioner has no local standi and there is no violation of fundamental rights and the petition is against the public interest. Firstly, coming to the locus standi of the petitioner, even though the Supreme Court has relaxed the locus standi of the petitions in the public interest litigations, unscrupulous litigants cannot be allowed in the invoking the writ jurisdiction of the High Court. Unless there is an infringement, they cannot invoke the writ jurisdiction, was said in the State of Orissa versus R.C. Indrakumar case. The petitioner in the present case is the mere busybody or interloper who is just invoking the jurisdiction for a publicity interest litigation and not a public interest litigation. It was also held in Goa Foundation versus Konkan Railway case that the court should not subserve the private interest detriment to the public at large. In the present case, the policy is formulated in public interest, and so the petitioner has no locus standi to file a petition against it. Also, coming to violations of fundamental rights, there are no violations of fundamental rights, but only reasonable restrictions that have been imposed in Article 19(1)(d) and Article 19(1)(g). That was implemented only in the interest of the public. It is a well-established fact that public health cannot be allowed to suffer, which was held in Ajit Mehta versus State of Rajasthan. Also, the writ petition should be advanced to for the cause of justice and not to defeat the court's government's benefit to the public. Next contention.
Reasonable restriction has a specified limitation as well. And here they are extending it for 2 years at a stretch. So do you really think that it is reasonable restriction or arbitrary action?
It is a reasonable restriction, Your Ladyship, because under the Article 19(5) and 19(6), the Constitution gives power to impose reasonable restrictions on the fundamental rights.
And what about limitation? What about limitation? I mean, 2 years. 2 years at a stretch.
Indeed, Your Ladyship, the condition in the state is very worse, that the people's health is very much affected and the children's health are very much in danger due to the air pollution caused in the Wakanda state. And keeping
then,
all these...
Then, according to you, in India, lockdown should extend for 2 years at a stretch. Health issues are also here. We are under a pandemic.
Indeed, not, Your Lordship. There is only reasonable restrictions and exceptions.
Then how can it extend there? Then how it can extend there for 2 years if in India it cannot extend now after having such a worse... Delhi alone has 2 lakh cases of coronavirus, leave alone the entire country. Delhi alone is suffering very badly. So we should extend the lockdown for 2 years?
No, Your Lordship. Indeed.
Then why in Uganda? Why are you so unfair to Uganda people?
In the Wakanda, if the air pollution is coming from very worse to less severe, the restrictions can be put down. And
in India, okay, so you are demeaning the life of Indians then by not extending the lockdown. You want them to suffer and die. Extend the lockdown here also. You should. Why are you not supporting lockdown, extension of lockdown in India then? Extend it for 2 years at a stretch.
Not, Your Lordship. There are exceptions given in the present case to the people. And the lockdown is also extending without any notice. And I think it will extend to 2 or 3 years in India also.
Okay. Go ahead.
Please move on. The Supreme Court has long held that interference in policy actions is not within its jurisdiction. And it can only... interfere when it is arbitrary or unreasonable and not imposed in public interest. Undoubtedly, the policy is in public interest and it is reasonable. So, the court should dismiss
but
the present
petition. But it looks arbitrary. What if I say it looks arbitrary?
It passes the test of Wednesbury's reasonable test, Your Ladyship. So, it is not arbitrary.
Okay, so they does there is any economic plan or anything for Uganda that they have passed on with this passing of 2 year rule? Economic plans that how to cope with this?
Indeed, not, Your Lordship, but it is a well thought out plan only.
Then
policy
if they haven't passed any plan, then it is arbitrary. It's like I tell you that you are suffering from this disease and I don't give you medicine, then what? I mean, that won't make any sense, right? I will tell you, okay, you have fever, but I'm not giving you paracetamol. Then what?
Indeed, Your Lordship, this is
I mean, we extend lockdown here also without any plans. We don't care. Jo apne ghar mein, wo ghar mein rahe, jinke paas ghar nahi hai, wo na rahe. Who cares? Do we care? We have to care, right? We have to. We have to have a plan before lockdown. Because yes, even Uganda, as you see, acts as such a big population. India has such a big population. We cannot do anything without having a proper structural plan for the entire population. We cannot afford. I mean, we shouldn't be having the intention that people die. People will die because it is a pandemic. But then we shouldn't be taking it for granted that, yeah, it is a pandemic, so people have to die. This is not the idea. And this should not be the approach. We have to save our people. From the prince to pauper, every life is important right now. We don't care who he is, in fact. Okay, go ahead.
Coming to the second issue, the policy is valid and not arbitrary. As it was held that air pollution is not only a worst danger to the nation, but it is a danger to the entire globe. And it is the state's responsibility to control the air pollution. Under many subheadings, like under the international conventions and under the constitutional provisions, it is the responsibility of the state to discharge its duty to control the air pollution in the Wakanda state. Under Section 2 of the Environment Protection Act, it is very clear that environment extends to air, water and land. So it is obligated by the state that the environment should be hygienic for the people to live in. And under Article 21, the people have a right to have a pollution-free environment, and that should be given to the people. Also under Article 48A, 47 and 39E, taking all these articles into consideration, public health cannot be allowed to suffer, and this policy is in public interest. Also, the policy has been taken as a precautionary principle. When the condition in the Wakanda state is going to be left like that, the people will really suffer. So, as a precautionary principle, this policy has been applied.
Come to your prayer.
Much obliged. I have one more contention, Your Lordship.
Yeah, tell me.
Yeah, the policy passes the Wednesday's test of reasonableness and the proportionality test, and other effective means have not been held to be good as an alternative to this policy. And the reasonable restrictions are only to give effect to the directive principles of the state. So my prayer is to dismiss the petition and hold that the extension of the Green Wakanda policy is constitutionally valid.
Okay.
Thank you.
I'm audible.
Yes.
Yes. Thank you, Council. Since the other participant is not with us, so the point of rebuts and sir rebuts cannot be held. Thank you. You may leave the room.
Okay.